South Australian National Football League and the South Australian Brewing Company Limited proudly present live Sunday football, sponsored for your enjoyment by NEC, your Mitsubishi Motors dealer, and Hallett Brick.
Good afternoon and a warm welcome to the Elizabeth Oval for our live coverage this afternoon of the game between Central Districts and Norwood. Certainly ideal football conditions out here this afternoon. The wind at the moment blowing from the northwest side of town, and I would say that conditions will be absolutely perfect. Important game today for both sides. Of course, Central Districts looking to cement their place in the top three on the premiership ladder and therefore having, you know, a double chance at the finals later this season. Of course, Norwood looking to get back into the five following the loss yesterday of Sturt and West Adelaide. Just checking the scores from yesterday's rounds. Port Adelaide, 22 goals, 14, 146 points. Defeated West Adelaide, 15 goals, 9, 99. South Adelaide, a big percentage win, 39 goals, 16, 250. Defeating Woodville on 19 goals, 14, 128. And Glenelg, 27 goals, 15, 177 points. Defeating Sturt, 21 goals, 14, 140. And the clash between Torrens and North, Torrens 150 points, defeating North Adelaide on 119. And the premiership table as it stands at the moment, as we take a look now, we see Port one game clear on top from Glenelg, then Central's South and Sturt in the five at the moment, but of course Norwood just out on percentage, then West, Torrens, Woodville and at North Adelaide. And just looking at the game between Centrals and Norwood, both sides have met on 47 occasions and really it's quite a close tussle. Centrals have won 20 and Norwood have taken 27, while here at the Elizabeth Oval they've met 19 times, with Centrals winning 9 and Norwood winning 10. Well, Robert Odie again with me here at Elizabeth Oval. Of course, the commentators will be Ian, Dave and Peter Marker. Robert, perfect conditions and a great game it should be, and a vital game for both sides.
Should be, Rick. Thanks very much. Good afternoon, everybody. It is going to be a great day. That wind will play a bit of a part in the game, though, I feel, Rick. It's quite firm out here. It will carry the ball, I reckon, 10 metres on a decent sort of a kick. So the team kicking to the southern end is going to have some sort of an advantage, and I would think that winning the toss would be fairly important.
Looking at the Norwood side, Neville Roberts out. That's a big blow. He's been kicking numerous goals this year.
Yes, we've talked often the last few days about the positioning of the various sides, and Norwood in particular, how they play their full forward line with Neville Roberts in the pocket. They always play the big tall ruckman resting at full forward. They obviously do that for a reason. I suppose they like to have the big fellow standing in the goal square, and Neville works far and wide up in that forward line. And today Danny Jenkins gets the role, the captain, coming from half back, wing, half forward, and now he finds himself in the forward pocket, and they'll be looking for him to get a few kicks this afternoon and a few goals. He's a good mark too, Danny Jenkins. He can leap and fly, so he will be a very worthy replacement for Neville Roberts.
And speaking of the Norwood team, just a short time ago I spoke to their coach, Neil Balme. Neil, football's never an easy game, but would 84 rate as one of your hardest years so far?
Well, the way we play, every year this time of the year has been hard. You know, if we look back over the... Probably last year was the easiest in those terms, but it's much of a matchless, I think. I think right now it's hard because we've got to win most of our games in the run-in, but it was similar. We were in a similar situation over the last 4 or 5 years anyways.
You got off to a slow start again this season, your first six rounds, results not encouraging. Why do you think that was?
Well, there's a lot of reasons for it. We were a bit down on players, and we had a lot of kids that we thought could play but hadn't played them yet, and they hadn't had any experience. But now we've probably got 28 or 29 and we reckon could play pretty good league footy right now.
Looking towards the final five this year, you're just about clawing your way back in. Perhaps the best position you can make is fourth. Have you got any long-range plans looking towards the finals?
Well, not really. It's really, you've got to take it game by game. That's been said a million times, but that's the only way to do it, because it's one at a time is the way they come up. And I think a couple of times we've just played that way and won a few games and finished up even in the top three over the last couple of years when we hadn't expected to. So, you know, if we just win our games, and then what the other teams do is their problem, I think.
Norwood's got a very good depth of juniors. Has it been a concerted effort by the club to build that up looking towards future years?
Well, it certainly has been. I think most clubs try and do that. We've been reasonably successful. We've spent a lot of effort and perhaps even a fair bit of money in setting up our junior setup in terms of the work we've done in our area, and now with the other three teams on top of the ladder, I'm the only coach who hasn't got a team in the five, certainly on the top of the ladder. So I think that's the only way that you can look at footy. If you just want to buy from Melbourne or buy from other clubs, it's very expensive and also very risky. But if you just concentrate on your juniors, work in your local community, I think you've got a much better chance of having a better side in later years.
Do you have personal involvement as well with, say, juniors coaching?
Not as much as perhaps I should, but it's really very time-consuming, just this one side thing. But we've got a lot of people who do spend a lot of hours in our junior setup, both under-19s and under-17s, as well as, you know, much younger than that.
Neville Roberts not playing today. We've seen him play a lot of his game in the forward pocket. You've rested your ruckman quite a great deal at full forward. Why has Roberts never really been tried at full forward?
Well, as I said, it doesn't matter what you call him. I mean, you call him half forward flank, forward pocket, full forward, he still play the same game. Nowadays, it doesn't matter where you play, you've still got to cover a great deal of ground. The other thing behind that, we always like to play our ruckman on the field. We think it's a luxury to leave big blokes off. But sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't. But, you know, we probably haven't had enough goals out of full forward.
And, of course, we mentioned you've got a lot of juniors. Maybe just looking through those ranks, do you see a specialist full forward maybe coming up?
Well, I've never really been a believer in the fact that you need a specialist full forward. I've always felt that if a bloke can play full forward, well, perhaps he should be playing somewhere else, because there's not a lot of work to do there. Naturally, a 100-goal full forward is important to you, but a 6'4" or a 6'3" who can run and catch maybe should be sent half back or playing in the ruck or whatever anyway. So there's no, you know, I think a lot of the kids you look at, it doesn't really matter where they're playing right now, because when they play league footy, they may play in a different position anyway. You find that most of the good junior kids play centre forward, centre, ruck or whatever, whereas later on a lot of your centre back, fullback types have come from those areas.
Just looking at your recent form, you got off to a slow start, as I said earlier, but you've now won five of your last seven. What is the pinpoint reason for that?
Oh, I think we've just found a few players and we've just settled down, and the players have realised how difficult the year was going to be and been prepared to knuckle down to the task each week. Earlier on we had some pretty indifferent performances where we sort of lost a bit of confidence in ourselves and just stopped playing our game, got a bit lazy, got a bit disappointed, but that never solves anything. I think our consistent performance has been there, and each week, each quarter, we've kept at it and perhaps fallen in a couple of games, but it's as much as anything else attitude. But we have found a couple of players too, and Andrew Jarvis is playing very good footy, Rowan Helly has become a good solid halfback flanker, who are two that earlier in the year we thought maybe, maybe not. So, you know, with those blokes along with our other more recognised players, we're starting to be a bit more balanced.
We hear of clubs nowadays getting together socially with trips to the cinema and so forth. What's Norwood's feeling like off the field? Are they a good close-knit bunch?
Well, probably because of the way we are. We're not as close perhaps as we'd like, but there's so many different personalities. But over the last 4 or 5 weeks, we've had a good look at ourselves and a concerted effort to try and get them places together. Because I think that's a very strong force within a side. If the whole 20 blokes sort of live together, if you like, and socially move together, they get to know each other better and therefore move better on the field. So it's something that we've tried to work on.
Looking forward to today's game. It's a vital game for you in that chase for a final fifth position. We said earlier, no Roberts in the side. It's going to be hard.
Well, it's always going to be. We always find it hard here because Centrals, you know, seem to enjoy playing on their own ground, and there's a lot of space, and they really do work very hard and run very hard. So it's always a tough job down here. I think no Roberts is obviously going to change our style a little bit, but with Danny Jenkins playing there, he's a similar type where he's a good lead, he will draw the ball because of his experience, and he's also a very good good catch for his inches. So it will certainly be a little bit different, but perhaps it'll help us in a way, because I think over the last 6 or 8 weeks, you know, we've relied so much on Neville to kick goals that perhaps we've kicked it to him too often. And in impossible position where he's probably trying to make a bit of space, we've kicked it to him and he hasn't really wanted it. So maybe in a way it's good that he has a couple of weeks off.
You've had problems in ruck, as have a lot of other sides, but your brother's form has been very good. You must be happy.
Well, I don't think he does enough work, but I think he tries to. He needs to improve a bit. But some of his work, I thought last week his hitting out was very good, particularly around the boundary line, better than it has been. And he's got a lot of potential up forward, which sometimes we don't realise, but he can kick some goals there. And Neil Hine, I think, has been playing very well too.
And just looking at Centrals, any particular area there that worries you?
Well, I think they've got just the way they play here, the way they really push hard and run. And if you have a look at their side, they're pretty quick all over. Even their forward line looks a lot quicker than our back line. Their back line, they've got some quick players like the Barnes and the Hearns and the Pryors, who we've got to control the ball out here to win, because if we don't and they run it, we'll just be chasing them all day.
We wish you luck. Thanks, Neil.
Thanks, Rick. Thank you.
And to take a look at how the two sides will line up this afternoon, here's Ian Day and Peter Marker.
Good afternoon, everybody. Well, it's a beautiful sight up here at the back of the dog stand. Everything looks green. It's a fine afternoon. A pretty brisk breeze, probably worth 2 to 3. As you're looking at the screen, it will favour the right-hand side. But the dog's a little bit thin and ruck at the moment, but they're going to line up as such. Mark Norsworthy, Rob Fraser and Wilbur Wilson. Connelly, Bubnver, Van Dommele across the half-forward line. Grant Edwards, Peter Krieg and Peter Vivian form the centre line. Bunga Hearn, Brett Hannum and Stephen Boehm. The full-back line, Jamie Thomas, Michael Wright and Mark Pryor. The first ruck, Beythien, Rowan Platten, and the interchange players, Phil Graham and Ian DeRouge. Peter, the Norwood team.
Well, despite Roberts not being in the side, they haven't changed it around that much. There's Jenkins in the forward pocket, Hine resting at full forward, and Ross Payne, a big goal kicker, I think, in his last senior game, Kelly and Gallagher. Thomas, McIntosh, Dickinson across the centre line, Hellier, Warhurst, Jarvis, Keem, Michael, Annie Winter. First ruck there, Craig Balme, Michael Aish and Keith Thomas. Interchange players, Scanlon and little Albie Menzel. Rick Keegan.
Well, that sets the scene here at the Elizabeth Oval. We'll be back with all the football action after this short break. And welcome back to the Elizabeth Oval. Certainly a great scene down here at the moment, a very good crowd in attendance, and we're looking forward to a great clash between Norwood and Central Districts. Of course, Kevin Neale, in his first year for Centrals this year, will be talking to Kevin at half-time in this afternoon's game. Of course, he came from the Ainslie Club, and he brought quite a few recruits with him. And one of those has been Brett Hammond, who's been quite a solid rock in defence for Central Districts at half-back. He's very tough, has a very good straight rebound from defensive action, and he set up numerous goals for Central Districts during the season so far. And of course, the highlight for his career was that he was added to the state squad. Unfortunately, didn't make the state side, but he's one of the most promising and one of the most tough players in the league today. And Ian Day, I think another player who's in fine form for the Bulldogs is Peter Bubnver.
Sure is, Rick. He's a very important player. He provides the bit of height they got in front of the centre line, and he's in magnificent form, a magnificent athlete. He's a very versatile player, could play either in defence or in attack. Everything in readiness for the big clash. Umpire Rick Kinnear gets the game underway here at Central Districts. Fine afternoon. Your caller, Peter Marker.
Beythien in ruck for the Dogs. Barmore, solid whack there to Stephen Connolly, but he took it pretty well. Warhurst in there for Norwood. Gallagher was pushed in the back. The umpire didn't see it. He's come in now, though, umpire Laurie Argent. He will have another bounce. He didn't, in fact, bounce the first one. It was umpire Kinnear. Beythien and Balm again. Balm pushed it down towards Gallagher, missed him. It was Rowe that got the kick away. Winter and Wilson. Good mark, Bruce Winter. Read it well. He had the best position. Wilbur came back into him, but Bruce Winter has been around for a long time. Well, there's 15 metres. Rubbish, the crowd yell, but it's given and taken. The kick is to centre wing. Gee, it's dropping short. In front on that occasion was Stephen Connolly. He elected to play on, and a high tackle set on by Kinnear, and I think we're going to hear a fair bit from the crowd on this stand, mainly Central District supporters. Fraser goes short. Not Fraser, Connolly. He looked for Fraser, in fact. Rowe picked it up, gave it to Platten. Platten on the run. That ball coming back. Great running shot, Platten. What a top player he is. First goal on the board to the Dogs.
Well done, Johnny Platten. A lot of pace, very damaging player. Well, it wasn't a good kick across the half-forward line, and Trevor Rowe was the player that set it up, got the handball out nicely, no pressure put on Platten at all, and he strode out like he's fully recovered from that hamstring injury, and the Dogs off to a good start with their first goal.
Peter Beythien there, and there's one thing the Dogs are going to do today, and that's run. Down it went to McIntosh from Beythien. The long kick away to half-forward. Getting out there is Jamie Thomas. Couldn't pick the ball up. Jenkins has got the chance, but Thomas, in fact, will take the free kick. He plays it on, and it's Pryor who runs it out of defence for the Dogs. They're looking pretty good, and they're running hard. That was Bunga Hearn. He kicked it to centre wing. Edwards fighting hard for the ball. Also in there is Greg Thomas, but umpire Kinnear will come in and bounce it.
A goal to the home team. The visitors yet to open their account. Bounce down at centre wing. Umpire Kinnear. Beythien, getting up high was Balme. Greg Thomas gets the free kick for a high tackle. He'll go towards the half forward line, looking towards Michael Aish. Danny Jenkins there as well at the back. Up goes the little fella, got his hands to it, couldn't complete it. Gallagher through, but coming through Jamie Thomas, another high tackle. And gee, we've had a few in the opening minutes of the game. In the back pocket player for the Dogs, at centre half back at the moment, will relieve the pressure. The breeze has got to be worth 2 or 3. We didn't get a chance to ask Robert and
and Rick down there, but it's definitely favouring the end to which the Dogs are kicking. Going through Philip Graham, having trouble picking up the ball, conceding ground. Beythien wants it out wide, but he twists nicely. Kicks long now to the half-forward line, up towards Connelly. Wilbur's in the middle of that. Can't get it clear. Rowan Hillier can as he drives to the outer side. Rowe's got the chance if the ball sits. It does for him. Michael Ace can't get to him as he drives in towards Connelly, making a lot of ground on the outer side. Rowan Hillier there with him, and the ball is out of play once more. Just in case you are interested in the reserves clash, Norwood 19-15 defeated the Dogs reserve side 11-13.
The umpire will throw it in. Left half forward flank for the Bulldogs. Trevor Rowe has obviously got the job again on Michael Aish. Dickinson has the run of it for Norwood, but again the umpire will throw it in. Superb conditions here. The breeze is favouring the southern end. That is the end to which the Bulldogs are kicking. Doesn't appear to be much in it. Peter Bubnver got the knockdown on that occasion. Rowe again for the Bulldogs, puts it in short. Michael Aney is there. The push down is to Winter. He handballs it clear to Keith Thomas. Thomas runs it over the centre. Hannum is there, number eight. Door crashing the pack, Danny Jenkins. Lester Ross got the handball through. Payne there, but he can't do anything with it. Bunga Hearn gets the handball back. Krieg, the run now is from Pryor. The Bulldogs love running. Here's Wilbur Wilson in front. Up he goes, couldn't take the mark. Edwards there. Gets it out. Now it's Connolly. The handball wasn't too good. Graham's got the run of it. The tackle too long. Philip Graham has got the free kick at about centre half forward for the Bulldogs. With the breeze at his back, as I said, not strong, but sufficient to help. He is within range. And what a start it would be for the Bulldogs to have two on the board at this early stage. Nice looking kick. It's going across, but it's just shaved the post. Shaved the inside of the post, in fact. 1-1 the Bulldogs. The Redlegs have yet to score.
Jim Michael Annie to kick in. Possibly go to the outer side. No, he's that's the dead pocket out there. Yes, he'll go to the outer side. Looking for the lead out there of Warhurst. Bubnver with him. Norsworthy to Platten is good football. Chipped it out. Wilbur Wilson. Beautifully directed. Gee, he only needs a couple of metres. Got clear of Winter. And Wilbur Wilson's got a chance 30 metres out. Very seldom misses this Wilbur. Loves kicking goals. Shouldn't miss this one. Breeze at his back. Might have to take the right goalpost as he looks at it. Gee, put it in very low. And that's touched. He didn't make the distance. Trying to get it back over there was Fraser. He'll need support from there. Still working hard for the ball. Tackled by Michael Annie. Platten in the pocket. Back towards Fraser. Norsworthy in there instead. Gives it back now. Platten puts it in the air with a chance. The umpire starts to move. And it's offline for another point.
Well, Ian, I'm surprised they didn't get a goal out of that. The kick from Wilbur was, it was unusual. It almost looked as though he was kicking into the breeze. But he had the breeze with him. He pushed it in low. Platten doesn't normally miss either from that position. Winter kicks out. Gets plenty of distance this time. Coming across late is Balme. Aish in there. Ross. Jarvis. Gee, ducked the head. Bit dangerous. Ross gets it back. Not too cleverly, though. McIntosh fights hard, but beautifully done, Platten. Kicked off the ground, but a good mark from Michael Aney. Big Jim's got the job at fullback again in opposition to Fraser. Big leap there from Keith Thomas. Fine mark. He's roving today for the Redlegs. And Greg Thomas is on centre wing. Keith Thomas goes long. Craig Kelly behind Beythien. Trevor Rowe got the handball out. Van Dommel's kicked forward. Platten tried to keep it in but couldn't. That's out on the full.
Penalty kick on the outer side. Norwood through Rowan Hillier. Kicks long towards centre wing and I think he's repeated the dose. Stayed out on the full. Tit for tat. Who's going to get it on the outer side? Looks like Van Dommel. Now, it could have been Rowe again who drives up towards the big leap of Connolly, but I think he's given a free away. And Lord, player down there injured in Tom Worst. Umpire Kinnear just going in to have a look at young Tom Jr. And he doesn't look healthy at all at the moment. In fact, I think they will probably hold up play, will they, or won't they? Now, he's getting up now. And it's Keith Thomas who boots the ball out of defence to the outer side, thumped away by Edwards. In there was Ross, Norsworthy for the Dogs. Out towards Ross again. Players going down. Thomas at the bottom of the pack. and the umpire will come in and bounce. Let's have a look at Tom, how he got hurt. And, yes, it would have been the knee of Connelly. A big leap by him. Certainly got it into the back of young Tom. Here's a chance now. Beythien down the outer side, uses his pace, puts it in the air. Wilbur Wilson, Winter over the top now. Fraser, Platten through, leaves the football behind, but the umpire's picked up another free, going the way of the legs, and it'll be taken in defence by Bruce Winter.
Over the shoulder, the umpire called. He put it out wide to Ross. Lester Ross tries to get distance, holding up in the breeze a bit. Beythien back there, but a big leap over the top. The player we tried to pick up before.
Jamie Thomas.
Jamie Thomas it is. Thank you, Ian. That's Norsworthy. Gee, he appeared to be off. No, he's going to have to put it back to Jamie Thomas. We are a long, long way from the action at the back of this dog stand, I can tell you. The player's being stopped now. It's most unfortunate for Tom Warhurst. The stretcher is out there.
He doesn't want to come off, Peter.
No, he won't go off. I'll tell you what, he's one of the most courageous players to wear a Guernsey in this state. Tremendous performer, Tom Warhurst. Great to see him up, but I hope he's all right.
Peter, at least he should go off and have a spell, if nothing else. Just let the doctor have a look at him. But he's either severely winded or he's hurt the shoulder with that knee. It got him very high in the back.
Yes, he's coming over to the boundary line now to have a chat to the doctor. Wilbur Wilson in front. Big leap over the top. No mark. McIntosh puts it out, but the handball was smothered. Connolly's in there, and that's going to be holding the ball against Stephen Connolly. You'll find the free kick will go to Michael Aish. Now, the replacement Scanlon is coming on. Tom Warhurst is going straight down. No, I thought he's going down into the race. The doctor will come across and see if everything's okay or not.
Greg Thomas puts him out of defence up towards centre wing. Rene Van Dommel put the Dogs in to attack again. Bubnver gives him a lead at half forward. He's going towards that player. He's in a nest of legs, however. He's only one of about five flying. Winter having a lot of touches early up. Greg Thomas, the running player, is Andrew Jarvis. Comes off the half back line with a long kick. Gee, that's a ground covering kick into that breeze towards Jenkins. Getting held there when he hasn't got the ball is young Payne, and he's going to get a free kick on the half forward line. Well, I didn't think a break could come from behind. Well, that's a rule that I can't agree with, if it's right. But the free kick is going to Beythien. I suppose the umpires would say he's going to break off around the mark, but you should have the sanctity of letting yourself have a kick after free kick. Rowan Hillier.
Tom Warhurst went down into the race in, and Stephen Boehm just replaced Stephen Connolly, so there's plenty of action here at the moment. Let's hope everything's all right with Tom Warhurst. He's an important part of the setup for Norwood as Norsworthy kicks to the centre half forward. Good mark, Jarvis. Stood his ground well with Platten coming into him. Gallagher's loose in the centre. Yeah, Jarvis finally sees him. Gee, you're taking a bit of time to see the moves of the Red Legs today. Gallagher wants Ross. Ross decides to go long out wide. Danny Jenkins got position. Got a free kick. Now, the Norwood captain. Danny Jenkins goes in long. Neil Hines, the tallest player there in front. Got the ball punched away from him. Here's a chance now, Craig Kelly. Great smother on that occasion. Out it comes to Norsworthy. Norsworthy puts it over again to Wright. Wright into Rowe. Not Rowe, Krieg. Krieg now to Beythien. The Bulldogs are running better than Norwood. Beythien goes to centre-half forward. Wilbur Wilson, Platten. Take your pick. Platten gives Wilbur Wilson the chance. Will he miss two in a row? No, he won't. Dead centre, that one. 2-2 the Dogs. Norwood yet to score.
Oh, he's a danger man. As soon as he gets near the ball, the Dogs stand here erupt, and that ball was fired out into the open, and look at Wilbur go. Well tapped on by Platten, and Wilbur's there. Can't find Winter at the moment, and a beautiful kick for goal. And have a look at Wilbur's biog over the last 3 years. He's improved every year. In 84, he's averaged nearly four, one better than 83, and that's two better than 82. Wilbur, a very dangerous footballer.
Well, I don't know if that breeze is stronger than it looks, but I don't like the way Norwood is going at the moment. There's no run out there at all. Edwards comes in. McIntosh ran past the ball. Van Dommel wobbles one forward. Hellier, Bubnver. Hellier recovered pretty well then. Now Scanlon. Scanlon's got Keith Thomas. Keith Thomas runs into a pack of trouble. Boehm. Well done, Stephen Boehm. Through the pack he went. Close to holding the ball, but he got the kick away. Fraser. Wilbur Wilson. Winter. The tackles are on. Gee,
Graham tried to get through. He's going to get a free kick. I thought the umpire was about to free kick him. But they get out of trouble. Jarvis kicks long, but who to? The Bulldog players everywhere. Dickinson did well to get his hand to the ball. Gallagher tries to kick it off the ground. Misses. Van Dommel. Good handball to Beythien. Beythien long. Philip Graham in front. Good mark on the chest. Robert Fraser is going, drifting back now behind Michael Elliott, full forward. DeRue's ready to come on. Well, Graham's going short. Good lead. Fraser, the kick not that good though. Fraser around onto that left boot. Here's a chance. It's just about aimed for the umpire. Great mark, Philip Gallagher.
Gallagher got that low to the turf. Gee, he needed it. Norsworthy lurking. Short to Hine. He should get a long handball over here to Greg Thomas. That was well done, big fellow. He can bolt. The legs a chance to go into attack for the first time with any constructiveness about it. Drive to the half forward line. Up there is young Payne. He's going to get another one. Free kick rather than the mark. On the lead was big Craig Balme. Wright getting back. Wright in front. Fine mark. Kelly came over the top but found the Dog defender too strong. Only player on the ground wearing the long sleeve Guernseys. He puts it back towards the Rouge. He's 33. Thumped away by Hine towards the flank position. Payne goes out. Bung Ahern can't get it clear. Finally, it comes back now to Payne. He thought about Thomas. A little late, but he gave it to him. He gives a long one over now to Keith Thomas. Thomas to Gallagher. Gallagher's going to have to go for this. Put it out wide now. McIntosh. McIntosh bolts towards goal. Steady. Puts in a long one. Going right across the face of goal. Looking for it is Balm. Prior back there as well. But the ball goes out of pocket. Or out of bounds in the full forward right pocket.
Well, they look very rusty, the Redlegs. They're not well all at all at the moment. There's big Craig Balm against DeRouge. DeRouge is 33. Here's a chance. Ross got it out to Michael Aish. He's being well held at the moment by Trevor Rowe. Back to Aish from Gallagher. Gallagher in turn. No, Aish in turn to Dickinson. Gee, he's holding on to the ball. He finally got pushed out. And the umpire will throw it in.
Won't let them get an easy kick, Peter, will they?
No, they're desperate, Ian. They really are desperate. They love playing here, too. With the crowd behind them. Craig Balm. Aish down. For a kick, Aish. Trevor Rowe is right on him. Now, I don't know if Michael Aish can kick the distance. If there's any breeze, he's kicking right into it. Have a look for the leads. I don't think there are going to be any forthcoming, though. Michael Aish is going to have to try and make the distance. Ball, plenty of height. It's holding up now. Craig Kelly in front. DeRouge punches away. Players everywhere in there. Finally, though, the kick away from Platten. Fifth kick, Platten got plenty of distance with it too. Now Van Dommel tries to find Vivian. That handball wasn't good though. Philip Graham there as well. Gallagher with the underground handball. Jarvis a long way down and he finds Lester Ross. Well, they're sticking at it, Norwood. We've played about 15 minutes. Lester Ross gives them a chance again. Kelly there. I think he's going to be paid. Yes, he took the mark. Kelly at centre-half forward or closer. No more than 25 metres. Let's have a look at how he did it. Yes, he did take the mark. It looked as though that ball was going to drop to the ground, but not a bad effort either against Brett Hannum. Vital goal. Oh, he's dragged it. No, just stayed in. Oh, not a confident kick. The Redlegs have got one. One goal, they trail the Dogs 2-2.
DeRouge gets the tap away. Keith Thomas smothered the handball. DeRouge again, can't one grab it. Puts out a long one. Philip Graham a chance to run into attack. The tackle was high, going to get a free kick at centre-half forward. Robert Odie.
Tom Warhurst just in the club room, just having a rest on the table. He's got some sort of concussion, Ian. He's not in the best of condition at the moment, so he's just resting. We'll see how he feels a bit later on during the game.
Thanks, Robert. Philip Graham from centre-half forward puts in an awkward-looking kick. Gee, it's covering a long way. Wilbur Wilson, he seemed to have it, then lost it. Boehm hooks it back right into the teeth of goal. Getting back Stephen Keane close to the line. Quite happy to concede the point. As the Dogs move on now to 2-3, Norwood a goal.
Well, I'm surprised that Wilbur didn't grab that one. Normally he would. Bruce Winter thinking about it a great deal. It's Rowan Hillier loose on this side of the ground, but Winter goes out wider. Hine or Michelini. Michelini, his hands weren't very strong then. Vivian
conceding ground, but he'll push it back long. Wilbur Wilson on the lead. Bruce Winter, beautiful judgment to be paid the mark. Gee, you read that well. Been a fine player for Norwood this year, Bruce Winter. Well, that's not the best kick I've seen. To push in the back to Fraser. Probably too far out to score. Who have they got in the square? Boehm, an unlikely forward. And Wilbur Wilson. Bubner's coming in too. Bubner's a big leap. He went for the lead. That was beautifully read. Oh, well done, Bubner. And well read by Fraser. The timing of that lead was just so good. Bubner came, drifted in very late. He's put himself in a shocking angle, though. Michael Aney came right in then. Gee, the umpire was nowhere near it. Bubner must have completely lost sight of where the mark was, or Michael Aney went over it. One of the two. Van Dommel caught. Hellier got it. The kick is clear. Beythien and Dickinson right on him. One thing about the Milky, he's still got plenty of pace. Kicks it into the centre. Thomas ran past it. Edwards didn't. Hannum goes for the roundhouse left. Jarvis. It's a danger handball, that one, although it found Scanlon. He goes long. In front is Payne. See, Payne did that well. Put the handball across to Lester Ross. Didn't sit for him. Ross is caught. Gets out of it beautifully, though. The kick is towards Aish. Aish in front. Couldn't mark the ball. Now Dickinson with a run of it. Beythien is there, so is Hannum. Beythien was legged, and he'll take the free kick.
2-3 to a goal. The Dogs lead. Playing on quickly is Norsworthy to Philip Graham at centre wing. Boehm is in centre. He wants it. Going towards that player. Good mark. Playing on the half forward line today, as Peter's told you. Boehm centre field at the moment to put the Dogs into attack. He's asked to play on now. Great smother. McIntosh towards centre wing. Boehm had the pace to get there first. Used his body well. Back in defence is Pryor. Ball held to that player. Oopsie. Not held to that player holding the ball. Jenkins plays on quickly. Keith Thomas, half forward line. Fired on behind players. Thomas puts it high up towards full forward. Thumped away from Michael Aish. Getting back on it quickly is Hearn. Has time now to clear as he puts it back, Thomas. Gee, he's lucky to get that one to sit nicely for him. It was an awkward one to take. He comes through centre half bait. Back, gets out a long one. Krieg a chance now. Got to get round McIntosh. The handball away is not good. Philip Graham twists and turns, gets collared. Rowe can't get to the football. In there as well is Andrew Jarvis, and the umpire will come in for a bounce down centre field. 2-3 to a goal. Rowan Hellier has gone to centre half back with the demise of Tom Warhurst, and Justin Scanlon has come to the half back flank. DeRouge got up the higher of the two and got the tap away towards Hine. Couldn't get a kick away. Norsworthy there working hard under the pack to DeRouge. The Dogs go into attack. Fraser on the lead. Good mark. The umpire's paid it. A hard one to take. Straight at his eyes. He jumbled it or fumbled it two or three times. Tried to get it, and the umpire said that was good enough. Let's have a look at it. One, two. Well, the umpire has paid it. It's about 40 metres out. Let's have a look at the kick now going in high. The umpire said it's home. A top kick, his first. 3-3 Central, a goal Norwood.
Well, perhaps a little bit lucky with the mark. Actually, the fight behind play that we talked about just in passing a little while ago. I'll talk about that in a minute. Look at the mark. Don't really think that was fully controlled in these conditions, but still. Yes, there's Robert Fraser, and he's been a good player, averaging 3.5 goals. Yeah, Michael Aish and Trevor Rowe were involved in it. Aish lost his headgear, and I think Michael's a bit uptight about the attention he's getting.
Hine against Beythien, who has to give away plenty of centimetres. He actually got his hand to that ball. Norsworthy out to the Milko. Beythien high towards centre wing. Standing his ground, Van Dommel. Scanlon over the top. Joining that player is Greg Thomas, but conceding ground to centre half-back. Around the corner. Norsworthy. Boehm did that well. Grant Edwards wants help. Back now to Norsworthy. Full face at goal. Over the half-forward line. Sets it up for Bubner. Doesn't need him. Has bounced number two. Heads for goal. Gives it a chance and battles it. Brilliantly done. Not a top effort then by the leg defence. First goal Norsworthy. 4-3 the home team. A goal the visitors.
Not a top effort, all right. Gee. They did it too easily. But the damage was done before that. Philip Gallagher had the chance to get a ball just defence side of centre.
didn't put his body in, and that was the result. It's a body game, this. If you don't put your body in, you're in trouble.
Again, Beythien got his hand to the ball first. Boehm in trouble. Platten goes in against Ross. And the umpire, not Ross, it's Dickinson, and the umpire will come in for a rebound.
Big Neil Hine there, number five for the Redlegs. Tallest player on the ground. Beythien's a useful ruckman, though. Philip Gallagher in there, and the player being grabbed was Krieg. The Dogs have got a break now, and they're a confident team, particularly out here. Krieg to centre half forward. Fraser comes in late. Big punch away, Michelini. Platten caught down, holding the ball to him, says umpire Kinnear, and he'll bounce it at centre half forward for the Dogs. Well, a huge leap there from Bubnver. Gee, that was a super leap. Down goes Winter, and that's a push in the back. The crowd wanted holding the ball, but I think that was a bit optimistic. It was either a push in the back or play on. I don't think it was holding the ball, though. Winter goes out long, centre wing, out of sight of the ground. Hannum is there. Now Trevor Rowe. Ross didn't quite catch him, but put him off balance for the kick. Bubnver. Stalemate there, and the umpire will bounce it. If Michael Ace is held in and they don't get any goals from Neville Roberts' replacement, the legs are in trouble, aren't they?
Peter, they need to run. Neil Balme said in that interview before the game that, gee, if the Dogs get the run on, the legs are in trouble. Rowan Hellyer kicks long towards the half forward line. Leap by Kelly, not successful at the back. Hannum, fine mark, elects to play on. The running player now through the half forward line was going to be Pryor. Got a second chance a little luckily, although he lost it then. Payne through, Payne out, Beythien in. The Dogs with another chance, intercepted well, Michael Ace. Rowe's been given the job by the looks of things as he kicks to the half forward line. Gallagher against Hannum. Hannum on the half back line. Gallagher doesn't appear to have a lot of run today, and he's struggling a bit. I thought Michael Ace looked a bit sluggish as well, but maybe it's just Trevor Rowe not giving him a centimetre to play with that's creating all the damage. Brett Hannum off the half back line, goes in short. Beythien. What a big job this afternoon. Jamie Thomas, he'll bolt, no pressure put on him. McIntosh can't catch him. Long kick, half forward line, out in front of Platten. Fine mark. Oh, gee, made a metre to get there. The little fella's legs were going like a thrashing machine. Off goes Bubnver. Norsworthy as well, puts it in long. What a magnificent kick, but gee, it's high, wide, and very handsome. Well, not very handsome, as it was out of bounds on the full by at least 5 metres.
Well, I think there must be a bit of breeze going to that southern end. I don't think I've seen Johnny Platten kick so far. Michelini having a big think about it. Comes grandstand side. He really had to. Neil Hine. Ace fell over. Hine couldn't mark it. Who's going to get the free kick? A high one to Neil Hine. He plays it on. Not very intelligently, though. Keith Thomas. Undergrounds one to Jarvis. Do they look sluggish? The Redlegs very, very sluggish. It's a different ball game out here. You've got to run. And they're not running. Back towards Thomas. Oh, danger as he put it out in front of him. Platten's got it now. Ace won't grab him. Platten bottled it. No touch. Michelini touched it. He signified, yes, I touched that. The umpire agreed, and it's now 4-4 to Norwood, one goal.
I think Johnny Platten would be a little disappointed. He had the pace to beat Michael Ace, but I suppose that pace that he had to get to beat him just put him off kicking a little to the outer side. Dickinson up in front. Winter. Justin Scanlon. Well done, Wilbur Wilson. Winter again butters up. This time back to Michelini. David Dickinson back in defence. Gee, they've conceded about 40 metres and finally out to Stephen Keane. He comes off the half back line and directs play towards centre wing out of sight. Getting back by Thien. The handball away wasn't good. Vivian looks for Hannum. Going to run into trouble. Bubnver against the tide. Fine tackle. Oh, Rowan Hellyer, I think the umpire had paid the mark, but allowed Norwood to play to advantage. The ball goes close to the line. Hearn's quite happy to see it go out. Half forward right flank throw in. Norwood in attack and down by 22 points.
Poor little McIntosh is tackling very hard. He's appealing for free kicks on the tackles. He's not getting them. Beythien got his hand to that ball. Backs up pretty well, but pushing the back against Beythien, and the free kick will go to Philip Gallagher. Gallagher to centre half forward. Boehm went for the big smash. Now Ross.
couldn't quite get through. Danny Jenkins wobbles one forward, shocking kick. Bunga Hearn there, playing a lone hand in defence, kicks out. Straight back to McIntosh though. Well, not good. Neil Hines on his own. The lead though from Payne. Gee, that was a terrible kick from McIntosh. The siren is gone. The first quarter is over. A good one for the Bulldogs. They lead 4-4 to the Redlegs, one goal.
Quarter time at the Elizabeth Oval, and the home side certainly going great guns. Four goals, four, 28 points Central Districts at the moment. Norwood, one straight goal, 6 points. And just checking the stats from the first quarter. In the kick department, Central Districts 66 to Norwood's 44. Marks 17 to 15. Handballs 36 to 31. The frees, well, Central Districts have had 9 to Norwood's 11. And the rucks, one out of centre. Centrals have won 3 and Norwood have won 1. Firstly, Robert, Ian and Peter have been talking about the conditions and the breeze. From sitting down here, it's definitely going across the ground, and we have seen the ball occasionally just hold up a fraction.
Yes, when Norwood went into attack, it's holding up a little, particularly when they're coming in from the eastern side of the ground. And there's no doubt, though, that it's a trailing breeze. That screw punt that John Platten kicked that quarter, a prodigious kick, just indicated that if the ball's timed, how much further it will carry. But probably the big thing that quarter was the loss of Tom Warhurst. No doubt would be unsettling to Norwood, but fortunately for them, they had Justin Scannell on the reserves bench. And their centre-half back now is Rowan Hellier. He's moved across to stand Peter Bubnver, and Scannell going on to the half-back flank.
You talk about the Central's attack. You've already mentioned Platten back from his injury. He's dynamic, and with Wilbert, they're two great forces to have up front, aren't they?
They are. The thing about it is they've got to be watched, even if they're not having a good day themselves. You've only got to give them half an inch, and sure enough, they'll be into the play. I'm also for Centrals. They're doing some interesting changes off the reserves bench. We're trying to keep track of them here, but there's no doubt at the moment, I don't think, that Michael Ace is being followed around the ground by Trevor Rowe for the whole day, and that means that at times Stephen Boehm has a run on the ball when Ace goes back to that half-forward flank to have a rest and is followed back there by Rowe. That means Boehm suddenly finds himself running around the ground, and on several occasions that quarter we saw Stephen Boehm up in the forward pocket.
Thanks, Robert. Second quarter here at Elizabeth. Incidentally, mentioning Trevor Rowe on Michael Ace, he's had 5 kicks and 2 handballs. So in his own right, he's playing well as Platten sends the Dogs into attack towards the half-forward line. Winter back there, gets it out now towards Hellier, backing up Scanlon. The long handball goes out to Greg Thomas, but Edwards cuts that off. Thomas having to rescue the situation towards the half-back line. Equally pacey, however, was Edwards, although the Shepherd was used well. Thomas got it back to Ace. Rowe, the tackler again. Gee's wearing Ace very closely indeed, or Ace is wearing him closely, I should say. And the umpire is going to get a free kick out of all that. And on the half back line, it's gone to Justin Scanlon.
Being held on to, in fact, he kicks to centre wing. Kelly comes in high for the punch away. Couldn't affect it. Players stack up and the umpire will bounce it. Well, big Craig Balme's running in now for this ruck contest, but I would think that in the next 10 minutes we'll see whether Norwood are going to be good enough to make a game of it. Beythien up very high, punches it down, but it's out. The umpire will throw it in centre wing. 4-4 the Dogs. They lead Norwood a goal, and in that first quarter, Wilson, Fraser, Norsworthy and Platten got goals. Gee, Beithien's doing a fine job in ruck. Platten couldn't quite grab the ball. Ace went down. Rowe is there. The umpire will bounce it again. Umpires in charge today, Rick Kinnear and Laurie Argent, arguably the top umpiring partnership in league football. Ace caught again by Rowe. Gee, he won't give him an inch. And, well, they often say, Ian, if you beat Michael Ace, you go a long way to beating Norwood. I don't know whether that's so, but certainly part of it.
Yes, well, Rowe's getting kicks as well, Peter. Michael Ace certainly a dynamo, as is McIntosh and Thomas. This is Greg Thomas that sends him to the half-forward line. Big Hind can't half-volley it. He's grovelling after the ball, bottling it up, and it's centre-half back for the Dogs. A bounce down will take place. Just watching Michael Ace run in now, and this left of your screen, I don't know whether he'll be coming closely enough, but gee, Rowe is just right next to him. You can see him chasing him out the right of the screen there now, as Ross gets the ball, gives it back to Greg Thomas. Thomas conceding ground. Now he straightens up and puts a long one across goal. Dickinson with Vivian. Good mark, Dickinson. Had one hand retarded and grabbed it with the other one. Hine in the pocket. That's where the ball could go. The big fellow. Out comes Moore, but Hine's got it. Not Moore, right. Hine has got it. About 25 metres out. The angle's in your screen.
Terry Moore retired last year, eh?
I think it's Terry Moore. He retired, and they look a bit similar, don't they, Peter? Like they've got two arms and two legs each. When they're standing up on their backs to us, they look exactly the same. Neil Hyde. Gee, the legs need a goal. Coming back with a breeze. That's well done, Neil Hyde. Puts on his first, the legs second. They're two goals without a miss, and Central District's 4-4.
Well, there's no doubt that he is a vastly improved player, Neil Hyde. He's not quite there yet because, well, players that tall, they seem to take a little bit longer to mature. But Dickinson put it into Hine on the lead, and it was a good lead. He got down to that one for a big chap. And been around for a little while now, Neil Hine. He's averaging 21 hit-outs, which is a good average. So Norwood are two goals. The Dogs are 4-4.
Balme in ruck at the moment against Beythien. He's been getting the taps. That time it was Balme, but taken by Edwards. He kicks to the half-forward line. Norsworthy charged to meet it. The bounce favours Wilbur Wilson. Hooks around the corner. The umpire does not move. Second goal, Wilbur Wilson, and a quick reply to the Dogs.
Well, the amazing thing about that, Ian, was the way that forward line was so open. Look, it's just a complete paddock. It went through to Wilbur. Don't call that luck, because Wilbur does that too often for it to be lucky. He read the ball beautifully, and that was just his right angle for the left foot curve. 5-4 the Dogs, Norwood 2 goals.
At the centre bounce. Balm and Beythien. Once again, Balm got his hand to the ball, but the Dogs take it away again. Platten, Bubnver, Platten in the 1-2, through the half-forward line, goes home long again. This one's going to bounce through. Oh, he got a shocking bounce. It was a right-angled B-grade bounce that took it through for a minor score.
Well, I might have to revise my thinking about Platten's kicking. I said that he must have had the wind with him with that screw punt in the first quarter, but he got a lot of distance with the left boot then. It's great to see Platten back in action. Michael Annie kicked off. Big mark there, Bubnver. He'd be one of the biggest leapers in the league, Bubnver. The lead is on from Fraser. Oh, behind Wilson. Read it superbly. How about that? It was odds on that either Fraser or Michael Annie were going to touch it, but Wilbur didn't think so. Well, now his shot for goal from a standing shot in the first quarter was awful. Two on the run he's got. I think I'll back him into this. Yes, he's got that. Three goals, Wilbur Wilson. The Dogs 6-5, Norwood 2.
Welcome back. The danger signal's up for the legs. And, Peter, I get the impression I don't think they can win.
I think you're right, Ian.
Gee, and Bruce Winter, although he's a fine player, he's certainly not as quick as Wilbur Wilson. And I wouldn't be at all surprised to see a move there. Perhaps Andrew Jarvis on to Wilbur Wilson, but simply Bruce, although he's playing well on his own right, hasn't got the pace to go with him. Breaking through was Krieg, can't get it out. Edwards can. Drives to the half-forward line. Wilson again. Late on the scene was Winter. Wilson breaks down onto that left leg, fires in another one. That's number four. Oh, what an exhibition. 6 minutes into the second quarter, he's blazed Central Districts to 7-5, leading the visitors 2 goals.
Well, he's had 5 kicks and he's kicked 4 goals. He's kicked 3 in 4 minutes. And he's so dangerous. Doesn't matter whether it's 70 or 80 yards out, because if he can run into a goal like that, he rarely misses. The crowd love him. He's a great player. The Dogs are 7-5. The Red Legs 2 goals.
Oh, what a game he's playing. Balm gets his tap away this time. Gee, the legs have got to get it one out of the centre square sooner or later. Krieg to Beythien is well done. A long kick into attack again. Wilbur Wilson over the top. Almost brought back a specky. Winter under pressure. The umpire will come in and bounce. And I think Wilbur, no, it's John Platten there that's lost a little bit of breath at the moment. Almost pulled down a brilliant mark.
Oh, what a top player he is. Super goal kicker, loves kicking goals. Wilbur got the handball out. Michael H beaten by Bubnver. Oh, it went straight through Michael Aney. They're rushing the goals, the Dogs. They're pretty hungry for them at the moment. They want to kill this game off very quickly. It's great being in the stand. You can hear those kicks every time they finish one. Through the goal. There we are. Platten got it. Platten got his boot to it. 2 goals, Platten. The game could be all over now. 8-5 the Dogs, Norwood 2 goals.
Well, Neil Balme, as I said, I repeat, he was worried about the pace of Central. and he had great justification. Once again, it was the ability of Platten to outrun Keane in the race to the ball. Even signaled the goal himself in his excitement. Watch him as he goes through, turns round, and there he signals the goal. Does that give them two?
Neil Balme, what does he do? Two to Platten. Dickinson. Gee, they finally got one away, Norwood, but they're going to be held up. Hannum, good mark against the tide. Norwood have got no forwards, and their defenders are too slow. Add to that, they're not winning in the centre, nor the rucks. They're not winning anywhere. Graham. Rowe. Good kick, Rowe. Peter Krieg has thought about going on. Now he does. Here's another go. Johnny Platten's got it. He bounces away. Puts the handball over. A big chance now for Fraser. He's running into an open goal. Uses the check side with a left foot. Two goals, Fraser. The Dogs 9-5, Norwood 2 goals.
Well, Peter, what a slaughter at the moment. Gee, do you think we're sitting in the right stand for it as well? They just cannot miss a trick. Platten and everything. Best on ground at this stage. Sets it up. Fraser ran himself onto an angle. Into the pocket. But the big fellow charged off. And how about that for confidence? Check siding on the run. Goal number two. 9-5 the Dogs. Two goals the legs.
Well, it's a big ground. It's a different ground. As I mentioned before, you've really got to run on this oval. Could be a repeat of Footy Park yesterday. Jenkins in the centre now. Michael Aish. Dickinson. Wobbles one forward. Craig Kelly. Hannum. Hannum puts the hand up. Too much experience for Craig Kelly. Bunga Hearn. Jamie Thomas. Gee, everything's coming off for them. Getting under that is Krieg. Punching away Lester Ross. The Milkman. That's a wobbly old kick. But the way they're going, it'll probably find its mark. Edwards couldn't get it. McIntosh caught. Boehm, Beythien. Here's another chance for the Bulldogs. Edwards, Fraser's on a lead. He's way out in front. In front. No, he's going to be paid over the shoulder. I didn't see it, but we might be lucky enough to see it in replay. It didn't appear to be there, but nonetheless, he's got the free kick and he's playing on. Here's Johnny Platten. Platten's got the mark. Well, best on ground, I'd agree. We'll see that one in a second of Johnny Platten's. The one of Fraser, I think, just a little bit lucky. But Johnny Platten, that was a clear mark. This is Platten's 11th kick. What a comeback. Can he kick his third goal? Can he ever? Three goals, Platten. 10-5 the Dogs. Norwood, two goals.
Well, he's everywhere. And have a look at this for strength. Not very tall, but he's the mighty Adam. He did it well, and the defenders of the legs just chasing Guernseys at the moment, averaging two goals and 22 disposals per match. What a fine play.
Not only that, it's all the hard work he does at ankle level. It frightens the opposition the way he goes in. Gallagher wobbles one out. Michael Aish won't get to that. Slips over. Does it well, Michael Aish. Oh, the handball under pressure, no good. There's his opponent, Trevor Rowe. That's holding the ball. Keith Thomas. Yeah, I might turn in a umpire the way I'm going. Keith Thomas puts it out wide. Danny Jenkins. I never did like White though. Jenkins on the run. Under pressure with Boehm. Boehm just got to him. Pushing the back though. It'll come back to Jenkins for another pop at the goals. Oh, they're trailing by 8-5. 12 minutes into the second quarter. Do you reckon the Bulldog crowd love it? I love every second of what's going on here. But perhaps we shouldn't write the red legs off. That'll go back to Gallagher. Gallagher will play it on. From a long way out. Sets it up beautifully. That was intelligent work from Gallagher. His first goal. Norwood have got three. The Bulldogs 10-5.
Well, I've said it before, but what a beautiful kicker of the football. He almost nonchalantly potted that. When Jenkins decided to give it across to him. Let's have a look at the free. There's a blatant push in the back. Stephen Boehm was never going to catch him, but when he put it across to Gallagher, he just nonchalantly took two steps and put it through of it and started running back to the centre. But gee, he needs about another dozen of those.
Well, I wonder if that goal will give the Redlegs anything. Hine got the hand to it. Krieg kicked in the air. Edwards will be caught.
Oh, it's on a bit in there now, a little bit testy, but oh yes, McIntosh is at the bottom.
The bounce down almost back in the centre. 10-5 plays three goals. The crowd strangely silent as the Dogs sprint away, bound away I should say. Beythien, a long kick to the half forward line. Wilson, within there was Hellyer. Thomas, out wider still Greg Thomas, well done back there. Norsworthy, Platten, in goes Hellyer. Norsworthy again, retarded, hasn't got possession. Out wide is Krieg, but Norsworthy will go straight home. A dog player down hurt, can't pick up who
Van
it is.
Van Dommele in.
Van Dommele, thank you, Peter. Norsworthy puts it in high, looking for Bubnver. Big leap. Winter, under pressure, Gallagher. Dickinson, Michael Annie. Norwood edge out of defence. A long kick back towards centre wing, 2-on-1. Scanlon, Hannum, Beythien, Vivian, Thomas, Andrew Jarvis. And him again, the ball out of play.
Well, pretty desperate stuff. Van Dommel's going to come off. It looks like an ankle injury to me. I think you can even see the ankle puffed up from here, just above boot level there. His replacement getting ready is Stephen Connelly. There's that man Platten again. Handball over to the milkman, Peter Vivian. Norsworthy, further on to Boehm. Boehm's a runner. Scanlon just gets to him. Bruce Twitty gets back. In there again is Edwards. There's a fight on. Edwards gets the kick away. Boehm is there, not Boehm, but Rowan Hellyer. They're still fighting. That's Keem and Peter Vivian. Oh, well, they're doing their own thing. We'll go back to the football. Byfeen's got the mark. Just the attack side of centre. He'll go short. Short he goes. Norsworthy. Oh, there's looseness. Looseness everywhere in the red leg defence. They're being hurt repeatedly by the mercurial thrusts of Johnny Platten and also that man Wilbur Wilson. Well, that's dead centre. His second goal, 11-5 the Dogs, three goals Norwood.
So easy. Norwood getting frustrated. There's a few skirmishes around the ground. Not that I'm suggesting that Norwood is starting all the skirmishes, but terribly important, this game, to both teams. The Dogs want that second position, and of course Norwood desperate to get into the five. And Peter, is it just Neville Roberts missing, or is it more than that?
No, it's more than that, Ian. They've got no run. I don't think they know how to play this oval. You've got to really work here, and if you run, it pays off. Get those open spaces.
Menzel on the turf. The bottom of the pack is Edwards, 26, and the umpire will come in and bounce. Umpire Laurie Argent, almost back in the centre circle. 11-5 to three goals. Who would have thought? Hine gets up high, down towards Ross. Socket away, however, by Krieg. Winter's kick is not a good one. Out towards Ross, centre wing, the outer side. The Leagues can't pick it up one grab. The Dogs certainly can. Menzel having his first kick long to the half-forward line. Kelly up, can't bring it down. Well read, Thomas. Gives a chance, Danny Jenkins. It's got a sit for him. Pushed off the ball brilliantly, Mark Pryor. Back towards Krieg. But it's Jamie Thomas who gets the kick around the corner, centre wing. In goes Krieg there now as he gets the handball out. Brett Hannum charges through, sets it up. Edwards again, he'll give the next one. Norsworthy, the Dogs into attack. A nice sit on the ball, Graham. Edwards wants it back, but Beithien's going to get it. Back to Norsworthy in the 1-2. Platten over the top, 30 metres out, he steadies. Could be number 12 coming up through the middle. Four goals, Platten. And oh, it's just an exercise for the Dogs out there at the moment.
Oh, they're too good. They're far too good. That was as good as you'll ever see down the ground. Even when they're in trouble. Falling over, the handball goes out. Johnny Platten was on the end of the chain. Beithien's off, Dearaugo on. Four goals, Platten. I said several weeks ago, I don't think that there are any better rovers in Australia than Platten. I still stick to that, even though I was criticised in some quarters for saying it. He's as good as I've seen this year and in any competition.
The Dog hierarchy, Kevin Neale, Dean Mobbs, and on the far side, Billy Cochran, one of the selectors. Hine, it was Menzel, kicked out towards centre wing, coming grandstand side. Rowe and his nemesis, or his Michael Ace's nemesis is Rowe. Dickinson. Norsworthy, what's the umpire going to do? Bounce it. Gee, the Dog fans want to push in the back. They want blood. 12-5 to 3 goals. Umpire Argent in front of the grandstand here out of Elizabeth. Daru's got the cap away. Graham looking for a free kick. Gallagher conceding ground. Tries to hook it around to Ross. He's got to stand his ground. Edwards there with him. The bounce favours Krieg. Gets it on the left foot. Lost his footing. Cleverly to Rouge. Hannon backing up. Connolly out wide. That's where the ball travels. Connolly's got Scanlon to beat. Off goes Boehm. He doesn't want him. Puts it in high. Bubnver, Platten, Wilbur Wilson. The crumbs, Norsworthy. The bounce goes against him. Gallagher. Kicks like a soccer player, but only finds Krieg back in the centre square.
Krieg having a think about it. There's plenty of movement up there. Platten's running around like a Mexican jumping bean. He goes in long. Bubnver up high. Oh, stolen by Wilbur Wilson. Over the top. Straight through to Fraser. His third goal. And the Bulldogs have gone berserk here at Elizabeth Oval. They're too good.
Well, Peter, another casual approach by Neil Hine here, and it should have been an easy clearance for Norwood. The big fellow had it at his mercy, and Wilbur Wilson couldn't believe his luck. Bounced his way into goal, gave it to Fraser, close to the line, couldn't miss. His third, 13-5, plays three goals. What a massacre.
Dead right. Hine, line ball in there. Michael H punches it away. Pryor gets the kick forward. Bubnver and Hellier, out comes Wilbur Wilson. Now Peter Bubner's got the run of it. He's a real athlete. Watch him go. Lines them up from 45 metres out. He's got it. Bubnver kicks one. They're all getting into the act. 14-5 the Dogs. Norwood, three goals.
Well, Peter, I've run out of superlatives. And even our boys on the boundary there are getting a little bored with the whole situation, or just lapping up the great play. Let's have a look. Heavy clash of bodies there. And, gee, what a mover. Straight through the middle. Goal number 14. 14-5, plays three goals. Peter Bubnver averaging 17 disposals.
Hine, line ball with DeRouge. McIntosh can't get out. The umpire will have another bounce.
Rick Keegan. It's a great quarter by Central Districts. In fact, their highest score for one quarter in a game of football, they kicked 9-7 back here in 1981. That was in the last quarter. But, of course, this quarter, 10-1. What a performance.
Well, the Redlegs are trying to make amends now as they go forward through Scanlon. Kelly in front. Reading it well, though, was Jamie Thomas. He's got it now. He threw that one out. The handball came from Payne. Keith Thomas. I think he's kicked straight to Michael Wright. How about that? 15 metres as well. Wright has got to play a short in Edwards. He's going to handball it to him. That's how easy they're going. Edwards short. Pinpoint pass to Krieg. Gee, this is too easy. Krieg, beautiful kick. Have a look at that. That's spot on. Tell you what, they're doing everything well. Philip Graham, now Platten. Platten's got the run of it with his left boot. Goes in short. Norsworthy, he'll run on. Lines them up. That'll come back. Have a look at that. Three goals, Norsworthy. Super football. You won't see any better. 15-5 the Dogs, Norwood three goals.
Well, luck's a fortune, or was it? Just really read it that way. How strong is that breeze? But once again, the mighty Adam beautifully hooked around the corner. Norsworthy, now that's going to miss by a good 2 metres. Back it came with the breeze, right through the middle. The Dogs can do no wrong. Bounding away on all fours, Norsworthy averaging 20 disposals and playing a brilliant game this afternoon.
Gee, they've kicked 11-1 already. Krieg again playing well in the centre. Hellier. Oh, Bubnver took it off him. Wilbur's on his own. Bubnver didn't want him. Goes in long. That ball coming back. I think it's just been saved by Michael Aney. Gee, Wilbur's a bit unhappy about that. He was on his own.
Well, something had to come unstuck, Peter.
You're not wrong.
Gee, the wheels have fallen off the Norwood bike, that's for sure. Michael Aney to the outer side. Over towards Hine. Drop that one. Edwards. Duck the chutney a little, but the umpire's going to pay it. High tackle. Edward bores in hard. Good play. Puts it in the air for Bubnver. Hellier there with him as well. Hine back at defence, and the big fella's going to be paid the mark. He'll run it out to Andrew Jarvis. Lester Ross is in short in the back pocket. Norwood have got to hang in there. But gee, standing up
12 goals, 6. Well, that's 13 goals. And we're not into time on of the second quarter at the moment. The Roos almost mark it. Michael Ace. Out goes Michael Ace. Solid bump by Bunga Hearn. Gee, put him to rest. Getting back on the ball is Justin Scanlon. Jarvis jams it onto the boot. Ace is up okay. Here's a charge, Thomas. He's run to ground. We'll need backup support. Pryor did it well. Krieg. Trevor Rowe. Stephen Boehm. Brad Hannum. Sided against the handball. Goes in short to the lead of Wilson again. Sits nicely. Wants a handball. Philip Graham going through the opening. Platten. Twist. Turns. Almost gets it high, kick away in towards Fraser. Wilbur Wilson's there again. With him in the pocket is Norsworthy. Says, go to it, Wilbur. Wilbur can't get clear. Norsworthy comes to help him. Back in the fence, Big Jim. He can't get it. Jammed off the boot there of Fraser. Or was it Edwards? He's in there now. Arms and legs everywhere, and a free kick sorted out to the leg defence.
Well, they need it. There's Van Dommel. We called it before an ankle injury. This is a bit of swelling in there. Big pack of players out there. Kelly from behind, and he's being paid. Well, I think this is the best quarter of football I've seen out at this oval. Two kicks only, Kelly. He's a forward player for the Red Legs. It hasn't been up there at all. Michael Ace lost sight of the ball. Trevor Rowe fighting hard, and the umpire will bounce it. Well, poor old Ross Porritt, the Red Leg runner. I don't think he's done so much work since he played halfback for the Red Legs back in the late 60s, early 70s. Changes all over the place. I was talking to Danny Jenkins a little while ago. I don't know where he's going to go. Kelly got the tap down. Krieg over to Pryor. Pryor goes in high to centre half forward. Norsworthy, the only dog player there. Good mark, Winter. Did it well. Winter's going to swing it out to Rowan Hellyer. Hellyer should go long. Get a great deal of distance though. Payne. Craig Balm. That was high, that one. The ball was there. Nothing. I don't think Balm did the wrong thing. I think he was going for the ball.
Balm ducked his head. No one backing up for the first time this afternoon. In comes Jamie Thomas. Got the handball away out towards Hearn. Put the ball out of play. 15-6. Plays 3 goals. Into time on of the second quarter. Norwood with another problem. Gallagher looks like a knee. Bubnver in. The Rouge was. Hine tried to get it out to Menzel. Payne got a high tap. McIntosh did it well. Michael Ace, if he gets the set, over to Menzel. Stephen Boehm back in defence. Can't get the kick away. Gee, it's hard in there at the moment. McIntosh comes in, but he goes out of ground. And Menzel is down now asking for help from trainers as well. Here to bruise up. Hine. And De Rouge. Michael Ace getting the free kick. Michael Ace, having only his fourth kick, puts it up now to the lead of Scanlon or Kelly. Kelly in front. He's got a good mark. Well, it's about the first positive movement we've seen from Red Legs for quite some time. Let's have a look at it in replay. Bubnver could never get there. Coming across trying to intercept. It appeared to be probably Jamie Thomas. Whatever, it's Kelly who's got the ball 30 metres out in front. Well, the Legs need a goal, but they also need divine intervention. Kick away is a nice one going. No, the umpire gallops. A point there first for the afternoon, 3-1. Central District's 15-6.
In just to show you how hard it is, this poor old Neil Balme, how hard it is for Michael Ace. He's had 4 kicks, 3 of them have been free kicks, and Trevor Rowe is wearing him like a glove. Shades of something that happened last week in Melbourne with Lee Matthews. I don't think that Ace's reaction will be like that though. Hannum holding the ball. I think the umpire's going to let it go on. Dickinson to Gallagher. Gallagher wants a space. Goes to centre half forward. Kelly one hand. Couldn't mark it. Gee, they're casual, the Red Legs. Don't give you the impression they're not really interested too much. Tell you what the Bulldogs are, though. They want 2 points. Plenty of percentage. And they want that top spot. It'd be pretty hard to get, though, because the Bays want it. So do Port Adelaide and so do South. Kick smothered. Jenkins. Oh, wobbly. Wobbly as you like. Michael Wright, with plenty of time, will run it out of fullback.
Mark Pryor, he'll go for a gallop. Vivian wants it. He's going over that player's head, coming across Craig Barr. Not a good pass at all on that occasion. No pressure on Pryor. Dickinson on the right foot, kicks long, right in towards full forward. Hind back there, but Wright again, too strong. And Michael Wright comes up a little gimpy, but standing the test of strength. Centrals, every time the ball comes in there, they're very cool, calm and collected about it all. Beythien. Holmes can go for a run. He's playing in defence, or possibly playing on the ball, as Robert told you, having a bit of a run. Justin Scanlon, a bit slow getting rid of it, holding the ball. And the free kick will go to Grant Edwards, is it? No, not going to be Grant Edwards. On the outer side, it'll be Connelly.
Connelly goes long. Getting under it, though, is Balme. The easy mark. He's going to play it on. Had Gallagher, but decided to go longer to centre-half forward. Big leap from behind, Jamie Thomas. Punched away beautifully. Pryor through the centre. Wobbly kick, but it nearly fell into the arms of Rowe. Philip Graham, straight through the legs of Winter. Wilbur Wilson slipped over as well at the psychological moment. Michael H. taps it through. Rowan Hellier. And umpire Kinnear will bounce it. Kinnear. Bubnver. Very high. Got the tap down. Platt fighting hard for the ball. In there, Scanlon. He ran the ball out to Winter. In turn, Jenkins. And Jarvis is the runner. Payne is outnumbered. Sandwiched in between two players. Bunga Hearn got it out. Greg Thomas. No, Payne it was. Backed up well. Here's a chance for Hine, but the ball has gone too far. It's coming back now. It's going to go through. No. Just missed. Point. 3-2 to 15-6, the Dogs leading.
Gee, Neville Roberts flying in hospital, Peter, whether he's listening to it on the radio or watching it on television. I think he's just pressed the button for another tranquilizer from a nurse. Either that or he's turned onto another channel watching something else. Hannum kicking towards centre field. Norwood going into attack again. McIntosh. Hannum again. It was probably Grant Edwards, the previous one. Hannum short to Beythien. He's at centre half back. They've got all the time in the world. Pryor over to Platten. Platten at centre wing. Goes in long now to Bubnver. Going to get the free kick, although the umpire's allowing it to go on. Connolly again puts it out on the lead. Is Fraser. There is Jim Michelani, Philip Graham, Michelani. Norsworthy over the top of Andrew Jarvis, and the umpire will come in and bounce. 5 minutes of time off. Centrals have kicked 11 goals, two in this quarter. The legs kicking with the breeze have managed 2 goals, 2. And there's the siren. So at half-time here at Elizabeth, it looks like it's game, set and match already. The score's 15-6 Centrals, 3-2 the legs.
Half-time at Elizabeth Oval, and Central District's doing it on the bit. They lead by 76 points as the players go down into the rooms, just recapping the quarter-by-quarter scores. At quarter-time, Central's 4-goal-4-28, leading Norwood on 1 straight goal, 6 points, and then a great second quarter by Central's, one of their best ever against Norwood. They're now 15-goal-6. They added 11-goals-2 in one quarter of football. They're on 96 points in front of Norwood on 3-goals-2, 20 points. They added 2-goal-2 in that quarter. Well, at the head of the show this afternoon, we heard from the Norwood coach, Neil Balme. Ian Day, a little earlier this afternoon, caught up with Kevin Neale.
Kevin, you said when you first came to South Australia it was important to have goals, realistic goals. Now, your first was to make the 5. You've done that. What's the next goal?
Yes, well, we started off initially to make the 5, and after sort of halfway through the year, when we'd had a reasonably good first half, we thought it wasn't beyond our possibilities to get one of the top 3 spots to give us a double chance in the finals, and that's the goal we're now working towards, to get one of the top 3 spots.
16 grand final games, or 16 final games you played with St Kilda. You had 6 grand finals with Ainslie. Were you in the final 5 situation with those clubs?
With St Kilda, in the latter part of my career there, we did play the elimination final. But at Ainslie, no, we only had final 4.
Obviously, you know what it's all about. How important is it?
Well, it really is another set of... not rules, but another set of circumstances. It's like a different competition when you get to the finals. things just aren't the same as they have been in the home and away games, and you know, there's a lot of pressure on, and players have got to be tuned mentally, and they've got to be strong mentally to win finals.
Looking at your chances of making the double chance, obviously you've got a problem in ruck. Now, Bruce Joycey, is that how you pronounce it? Have you seen him play?
Yes, I watched him play last Tuesday night in the Escort Cup game against Carlton, and while he doesn't take a lot of marks around the ground, he's got a good leap, and he does get his hand on the ball quite a lot. He's a good tap ruckman.
And what about Stephen, Trigg, Cousins and Mould? When will they be back?
Well, Triggy hopefully will be back next week. Cuz, he'll start running next week, so he'll probably be, I'd say, about a month away, and Mould's, he's about 5 weeks.
No, so that leaves you with a situation with Joycey. You could have three knock ruckmen ready for the final series.
Yeah, well, I hope that's the situation. I mean, I wouldn't mind having to tell one that we can't fit him in the side. But, you know, we realise the next six weeks is very important. If we can win four out of the next six, I think, you know, we can hang on to one of the top three spots. So this period coming up now when we won't have those ruckmen is pretty important to us.
Are there any other areas in the side which are causing concern?
Yes, well, contrary to, a lot of belief last week, a lot of the media sort of rubbished our game against North Adelaide, but I thought our back line and our centre line, I thought those nine players, that was the best we'd played all year as a team. We struggled up forward because we lack height up there, and at the moment we're just in a little bit of trouble with the full back spot because I've got to play Michael Wright there, or Peter Beythien, or Peter Bubnver, and Wrighty did well last week. Hopefully he'll do it again for the next couple of weeks until Paddy Swirt comes back, who I believe will be our fullback, or perhaps Stephen Trigg.
Well, who are you looking for up front to give you a bit of height other than Bubnver?
Well, I think if we can get a couple of our ruckmen back, that allows me then to use Beythien in the forward line along with Bubnver, and change the ruckman up in the forward line, which will give us a little bit more height up there. We're a little short at full forward, although Robbie Fraser's a good competitor, but we must have someone in the pocket behind him to offset that long kick. We kicked it in a lot of times last week and just didn't get possession of it because of lack of height.
You've had a chance now to assess other teams. Are there any that really worry you?
Yeah. All of them. Yeah. Yeah, you're right. Yeah. Well, that's the one thing that's pleasing about the competition here is while there's been a bit of canning of sides like Woodville and Torrens, they still have the ability on their day to get up and knock you over, which Woodville proved, and I think that makes it good for the competition here. And as far as having any sides to be worried about, well, West's the only side we haven't beaten, but I don't think there's anyone special there that worries us. They all worry us about equal.
You lost a couple at home. The Dogs don't normally do that. Does that concern you just a little?
Yes, pretty disappointing, especially the one against Woodville. And when you say that, it sounds like sour grapes. I'm not taking it in the way from Woodville. They wanted to win a bit better than us, but I was pretty disappointed with our performance. I thought we should have played a lot better. The game against Glenelg, we went down by a couple of points. Could have gone either way, like the first game when we beat them by three down there. So, you know, you win a few and lose a few that way. But the one against Woodville probably disappointed us, disappointed me more than anything, because we just didn't really play well at all.
You've been in South Australia 6 to 9 months now. Is the standard about what you expected?
Yes, Ian. I've been over the last 3 out of 4 grand finals and see a few games through the year on TV and such, and I had a pretty fair idea what the standard was like, and it's exactly as I thought it'd be. I've got no complaints about anything over here at the moment. I'm very pleased with it, and the standard and the organisation, everything is excellent.
Is there any aspects of South Australian football that's disappointed you?
No. I like the umpiring over here, even though they're coming under a bit of criticism. I'm not trying to be sweet to the umpires, but I think we let it go a little bit more here. No tiggy touch free kicks, which I believe gives the bloke going for the ball a little bit more chance.
You said when you were making goals, it was important to be realistic. Do you think you can go top?
Well, you know, there's a couple of games between third or top, or perhaps one game at the moment. You know, anybody can finish up there. It's just a matter of who does put it together when we play Port or South or Glenelg in the next 6 or 7 weeks. If we can get over the top of them then, well, there's no reason why we can't finish on top. But, when you get to the finals, as I said, it's a different set of circumstances. I believe we have the talent here. We've just got to be mentally prepared, mentally tough enough when those finals come around.
And welcome back to the Elizabeth Oval. Well, we've checked the scores quarter by quarter, but at this stage, let's now have a look at the stats from the first half of the game. In the kick department, Central District's about 112 to Norwood 78. Marks have been 38 to 30. Handball 74 to 62. The frees 15 to Centrals and 17 to Norwood. And the rucks out of centre, that's really where Centrals have dominated this stage. They've won 9 out of centre to Norwood's 4. So a pleasure to have with us at the moment in the commentary position here, the captain of Central District's in Stephen Trigg. Stephen, good to see you here. You've been out for what, 8 or 9 weeks now?
This is the 9th week, Rick, and getting a little bit toey having a look at that second quarter. I'd like to get back into it very quickly.
Of course, a broken leg's always very hard to come back from. Has it been tough getting back to your fitness? Are you fit now?
I'm not as fit as I'd like to be. I've had a little bit of trouble running in terms of long distances, and so my heart and lungs are a little bit down, but I think just a couple of matches and that'll be okay.
And what about your leg? Is it feeling good?
The ankle itself feels really nice, really good. It's solid and it's firm. But unfortunately, I've got a little bit of soreness down the bottom of the foot, which is a thing that you sort of compensate for it, and you get soreness in another area. And as soon as I can overcome that, I can play.
So your movement really is quite good at the moment, and you're happy?
Oh, fairly happy, yeah. I'm not as happy as if I was playing, of course, but I'm happy the way it's coming along, yes.
What about kicking the ball? Any pain there?
No, no pain.
So everything's going fine?
Yes, thanks.
That's great.
What about the position when you come back, Stephen? Where do you hope you might get into the side after today's performance?
Well, just having a look at that, I think it set me back 2 or 3 weeks, perhaps. I might have to wait for a bit, but I'm not sure. I thought that perhaps fullback could need a plugging, but Michael Wright's done well there, and I thought that halfback flank, perhaps, and the boys have done the job there, and then even somewhere across the half-forward line, and with the exception of Stephen Connelly, who had to go off for a while, they're all playing very well across there as well. And so... what about the interchange? I don't know.
what do you think about the game so far? Where do you think they've played so well? It's obviously impressed you, no doubt.
Oh, it's nothing short of that's the best quarter we've played so far this year, and I think that a lot of reasons. One of them is that our handball and our kicking has been very accurate, and our handballs have been wide to a player that's been running full face at goal instead of sort of messing around with the ball and going around in circles. I think that we've played very well in a straight line at goal. And the guys across the centre have done very well, like Grant Edwards and so forth. And, of course, when they get it down to Wilbury, can do the job, as we were saying off air before, with the 3 quickies in 3 minutes.
Peter Bubnver's a pretty handy player to have, to be able to play in the half-back line as he has in the past. Now he's a wingman, now at centre-half forward.
He's got a little bit of speed, hasn't he? He's got everything that it takes, and he's the sort of player that we need around the place, especially when you've got a lot of injuries, because he can play any position. And... last week we played North Adelaide, and in the first quarter he took 6 marks. And of course that's a little bit hard to keep up for a full game. It'll be 24 marks for a game, but he's a very handy player, as you say.
Thanks very much, Stephen.
Yeah, thanks for your time, Stephen, and we hope to see you back out there maybe in a couple of weeks.
Thanks.
Well, for this go, I'll go to Ian Day and Peter Marker upstairs.
Welcome back. Half-time score, Central's 15-6, Norwood 3-2, and as yet the Dogs haven't reappeared. Here they come now. Just a reminder, but straight after the end of this direct telecast from Elizabeth, we have a replay of the game from the SCG between the Sydney Swans and Collingwood. That's coming on at 5 o'clock, an hour's highlights of that game. Tuesday night, the Stirling Cup. At 8:30, we go across to see the Essendon and Hawthorn game. And then on Friday night, we've got a game at Football Park under lights, North Adelaide against Woodville. And that game will be replayed to you at 9:30 p.m. So plenty of football lined up for you during the week. And Peter, hopefully it's a little closer than the two we've seen the last 2 days. Firstly, South yesterday against Woodville, and now the Dogs against the Legs.
Well, I hope you're right, Ian. I still haven't stopped thinking about that game yesterday. I looked down at my calculations midway through the last quarter, and I suddenly realised that, or three-quarter way through the last quarter, that the Warriors had kicked 9. In that quarter, and they went on to kick 11, I think, in the last quarter. I guess that's the sort of tonic that Norwood needs, but in assessing the game before it started, Ian, I always felt that you probably had to kick 16 or 17 to beat the Bulldogs out here in these conditions. A firm turf and no rain. Now, I don't think Norwood can kick 16, ever, without Roberts.
No, Peter, their forward division's very disappointing indeed, and, you know, we're just talking to Pat Hall, former Norwood... Ruckman, and his son now plays in the reserves, and he feels that Norwood are not a final five proposition, and he feels they've got to rebuild.
Yes, and you know, when you start talking about rebuilding, of course there's a great deal of publicity about the enormous amount of money and time and effort that the Norwood club is putting into its juniors. Now, there's no doubt in my mind that it is putting in that effort, because if you look at the under-17s and under-19s and the reserves, They're going extremely well, but it doesn't show here, does it?
Yeah, not at the moment. And, well, I suppose you can't be a top side all the time. Norwood's still struggling to make the final five. The Dogs look as though they're in it for sure. And what a brilliant exhibition they've put on in the first half. Ready for the second half. A lead at the moment of 76 points, 15, 6 plays, 3-2. And the Dog fans still screaming for more blood. Beythien goes up. McIntosh takes the ball away as the legs go immediately into attack towards the half forward line. The bounce favours Greg Thomas. He needs support. Can't get it out the paint. Coming back, Edwards. He gets it over quickly now. Hearn goes short. Beythien. Rowe wants it quickly. So does Hearn, but Beythien not prepared to give it out just yet. Now he finds Rowe centre wing. Rowe from that posse puts it in high. Getting back Winter. Wilbur Wilson there as well. He pushed Winter underneath the ball. Scanlon's got to go. Connelly there with him. Wilson into the action quickly. What sort of magic she's going to line up here? He tried the handball. Michael Ace read it and patted it out of play.
Craig Barham at fullback in, and Michael Aney in ruck. He'll probably change at full forward with Neil Hine. Michael Aney got the tap away. He'll get a free kick. He got a slap in the face, and that normally means a free kick. Big Jim. No, he didn't go back for the kick. McIntosh. He doesn't look as though he can kick at the moment, Big Jim. He's limping a little bit. Ace will get another free kick. That's his score. Four free kicks, five kicks, Michael Ace. That's not a criticism. That's just an indication of how hard it is. In front then, but couldn't take the mark, was Payne. Plenty of Bulldog players there. They won't let it out. Finally, Bunga Hearn. Trevor Rowe. Edwards. Oh, he got a high one. He spins out of trouble, though. He got the free kick, played it on. Fine handball, Krieg. Out in front of Wilbur. Can't give him an inch, Wilbur. Fraser on a lead. So is Platten. Platten will get there first. Didn't get a good bounce. Jarvis. Robert Fraser it is, though, who leads in the race to the ball. Balme couldn't apply the tackle properly. A quick kick in from Platten, and Norsworthy marks it, not worth more than 10 metres from goal. Well, Johnny Platten in everything. 16 kicks, John Platten. Five handballs and four goals.
It's half time.
How about that? Best on ground for mine. Norsworthy lines it up. Didn't miss that one, and would you believe that's four goals, Norsworthy?
Well, the attack was a little messier than we've been used to from the Dogs all afternoon, but Fraser shrugged the tackle, and when things go right for you, I think that on that occasion, Platten just fired away, and Norsworthy there, given 2 metres by Andrew Jarvis, took the mark and did the rest. And the Dogs carrying off for where they left. Kick number eight, Norsworthy. But he's done a lot of bullocking work. He's a very strong young player, and he doesn't mind a bit of a scrap either.
Gee, Wilbur Wilson, Norsworthy and Platten, four goals each. They've been fine players. They've had plenty more. Michael Aney got his hand to it. Norsworthy kicked it straight up in the air. It's going to cause a heart attack for some of the guys waiting for it. Through the pack goes Edwards. Gee, he's been a good player too. Now Bubnver, also a top performer. Platten's there. Couldn't mark the ball, but have a look at the recovery. Onto the right boot, not far enough. A point, Ian, that's a super recovery, Platten, when he hits the ground.
Peter, his legs go, he's like Mark Naley, they go that quickly. They put Lester Ross onto him, trying to curb his influence, but, oh gee, I go along with you wholeheartedly. He's B.O.G. by proverbial street at the moment. Let's have a look, Balme gone to fullback. Well, that's interesting. Peter, you might have a look for a few more moves. They've got to make moves, they're not going to win probably in any case. Michael Aney looks to be in ruck at the moment as the ball goes to the outer side. Michael Ace gets one of his few kicks without being a free. Rowe doing a fine job. Greg Thomas rode that bump beautifully. McIntosh thought about Jenkins. He might get it now as he bounced down the outer side. The legs go into attack now. On the lead is Hine. Payne there as well. Hine goes in. Bunga Hearn back over the top is Stephen Boehm. And the umpire will bounce in the right forward pocket. 16-7 plays 3-2. Beythien against Hine. Norsworthy seemed to throw that one away almost as Hearn got it clear out towards Rowe, but he's close to the line, and a throw in on the outer side half forward right flank. The breeze is almost directly across the ground now, but players of both teams being able to score into it quite easily and getting ground covering kicks, so it's not a real disaster of a game. Vivian, a high kick to the half forward line. Scanlon getting back, doesn't want it. Bubnver, Scanlon in there now, gives it back to Lester Ross. Ross wobbles one out to the outer side, and it's taken out there by Michael Aney.
Big Jim in ruck, goes short, he wants Keith Thomas. Just finds him, the kick wasn't a good one. Thomas in turn short to Menzel. Menzel over the top to Greg Thomas. Gee, they're doing it the hard way. It might come unstuck. Kelly, Gallagher, it's a fine kick, lines them up. The umpire did not move. Two goals, Gallagher. Norwood 4-2, the Dogs 16-7.
That was well done, Norwood, but such is the pressure of the Dog defence. How many times did they touch this ball to get it about 40 metres? We picked it up pretty late. It was only the third time we saw it touch, but they had about five or six touches to get it from centre-half forward to Gallagher having a shot at goal. And that is a credit to the Dog defence. Phil Gallagher averaging 23 disposals. He's had a pretty disastrous year, once again with that injury, mainly the hamstring.
Beythien got his hand to it. Yes, he copped a high one. That's against Michael Annie. Big Jim has a chat to Laurie Argent. He goes past. Beythien goes long. Oh, well read, Bruce Winter. He's the only player that kept his eyes on the ball. He's had a bit of trouble with Wilbur Wilson in the first half, though, particularly in the second quarter. Jenkins went for the roundhouse right, comes back towards that player. It's a right half forward flank. The umpire will throw it in with the Dog 16-7, leading the Red Legs 4-2.
A question of pace. The Dogs have got it, the Legs haven't. Especially on an oval this size. Michael Annie, Menzel, Edwards, out of play. Gee, I would have thought it was his own player just about to push him in the back then. Edwards from half forward, right flank, got two leads. Wilbur's one of them. He's pushing and shoving. Has the ball, lost it. Philip Graham, he's going to be paid the mark. Wilbur Wilson, 45 metres out with the breeze. I said before he ought to make the distance from here. Let's have a look at it. Well, you be the judge. Wilbur Wilson goes off on that angular run of his. Hooks it in long, but he's hooked it too far back and across the face of goal for a point. 16-8, plays 4-2.
Gee, that one to Wilson and an earlier one to Fraser were more wet weather marks in terms of control, but I think the umpires are doing a good job out there today. Big leap, Winter, that was a fine leap. He's going to play it on. Jenkins, now Menzel. Menzel, not quick. Kelly, kicking it away as Pryor. Now Vivian gave the run to Platten. Platten's caught, won't get that one away. Philip Graham. Vivian again. Dickinson grabbed him just at the point of dispatch. Big Jim's handball was smothered. Krieg didn't do too well with it. Now Hannah. See what's he doing up there. Now Platten. He'll get into an open space now. Decides to go along. Now he blazed with that one too. And that went to Neil Balme. I'd agree with you, Ian. Neil Balme. Neil Balme's got a walking stick at the moment. Yes, I think Platten's probably blazed with his last couple of kicks.
Ball out now. That's well done to Dickinson. Dickinson goes towards the half-forward right flank. I think it was Kelly probably back there. And the ball is to be given to Centrals over there. I can't see what for, but whatever it is, they've got another kick. Pryor at centre wing to put the Dogs into attack again. They've been there most of the afternoon. A high kick. Bubnver sets himself. Hellyer there as well. He comes out with a football claiming the mark. A little bit optimistic. Platten. Through goes Vivian using pace. Hellyer wants to get to him. Vivian sprinting towards the ball. Takes out Lester Ross and the ball tumbles out of play. Some solid football going on out there. Throw in about 45 metres around. The Dogs by plenty. Bubnver behind. Mike Lanny in front who got the tap. Menzel couldn't find it. Through goes Rowan Hellyer, puts the ball back towards centre wing. The bounce favours finally Edwards. Edwards across goal towards half forward line. That's Edwards though. Hannum and Edwards, very similar. It was Hannum who got it to Edwards. Both blonde-headed boys. And he's got 15 metres as well, which brings him very close to goal. Only 30 metres out. With the breeze, umpire Argent in charge. Very little angle. He's been a winner for Centrals this season. One player that's come to the fore and proved that he's in league football to stay. Drop punt has not been given enough of the right goal post. It's going through for a minor score, 16-9, 4-2 Norwood.
Well, the sting has gone out of the game momentarily. We've played about 10 minutes of the third quarter and not as much action now as we first saw. Jenkins to Craig Barn running right down. He wants the handball and gets it. Not the best move though, although it's good to see the big chap working and doing something. You never know. They keep running Norwood. They might be able to get back into the game. I doubt it though. Jarvis finally comes out. Edwards, Krieg, short. Have a look at the pass. Bubnver. Norsworthy's down. Is he just having a rest or is he hurt? Just having a sit down on a pleasant Sunday afternoon.
Peter, I'd be interested to see how that ball came out of the pack there. It looked like a floated throw.
Well, anything's on today. Bubnver's kick missed. What a super pass though from Krieg.
Oh yes. Well, they can do no wrong. Handling the ball beautifully, and they've got the strength, they've got the pace, they've just got everything. Norwood can't take a trick at the moment, even kicking in, they find Platten. Platten's got it, half forward left flank. Norsworthy short. Oh, he's looking for 15 metres, the umpire unsympathetic. Fraser gave another lead short, he could still go to that player. No, he'll come across to Beythien. Beythien too far out to score, I think, unless he puts in a boom, and Norsworthy's closer. And that's got it, that's where it is. It's predictable. Norwood can't seem to see it out there, unfortunately. Only one man per each. Kick number 8 coming up. Had 12 handballs, though, and as I said, done a lot of hard work. Mark Norsworthy from 30 metres. Booted 4. It makes it 5. 17-10. Plays 14.
Gallagher got the kick away at the bounce for Norwood. It's now at centre-half forward for them, but the Dogs through Connelly. Holding them up. Pry got the kick back, but taken by Scanlon. Here's a chance now for the Red Legs. Hannum is behind, went for the big leap. He recovered first two. Close to the line, I think, yes, it's out. The umpire will throw it in. 17-10 to 14.
Wishful thinking, right.
4-2. But boy, it's going to be a big challenge for them. Can they reach double figures, I guess? Might be difficult. Big Jim couldn't get the ball away. Was that a trip? No, it wasn't. The umpire will bounce it just in front of the scoreboard, about 35 metres from the red leg goal.
The understatement of the year, the Legs need a goal. Michael Annie against Beythien, who got the tap towards the boundary line. Here's a chance now. Dickinson tried to break through, couldn't do so. Jamie Thomas back there, got the ball Beythien. Hannum can't find it. McIntosh can. Tears his way clear. Puts it into the pocket. Michael Aish puts it up now. Looking for Jenkins. Good grab. Used his body well. And the Kangaroo Island farmer has the ball about 25 metres out. Recruited to Norwood by Robert Odie. Well, he's been a great acquisition, Robert, over many years. A great team man. It's one plus for your young man. And there it is, his first. Well, I said the Legs needed a goal, and they've got it. 5-2, play 17-10.
Well, it wasn't a bad lead-up, but it was set up by McIntosh. He did the bullocking work. And, Michael Aish thought better of going for the goal. Gave Jenkins the chance. But 5-2 against 17-10. It's a Herculean effort for them to get back into it. He's averaging 21 disposals, Danny Jenkins, but he's missed a lot of football this year, and it's a bit unfortunate for him. Elevated to the position of captain, he hasn't really been able to give it all.
Neil High. Good bounce. Beythien gets the hand of the ball. Krieg knocks it further. A chance, Vivian, to the half-forward line. Going to it is Bubnver. No, Fraser it was. Couldn't quite get there. Boehm can as he drives a long kick out, very high to the outer side. Pryor standing his ground, can't. Quickly in now, Thomas gets it out wide to Dickinson. He's going to have to get his kick in a hurry. Not a good one as it goes towards the half forward line. Overrunning it there was Thomas in defence. I think he's grabbed when he hasn't got the ball. Or is that Trevor Rowe? Trevor Rowe it is, in the sunlight out the outer side. The man that's done such a good job on Michael Aish. He kicks the ball back to the half forward line. Getting back on it was Hine and Rowan Hillier. In goes Platten, doing the heavy body work as well. And a throw in on the outer side. 17-10 to 5-2. Played almost 15 minutes of the third quarter. Bubnver and Hine. Bubnver giving away centimetres. The ball tapped out to Vivian. Good lead. Good pass. Edwards on the lead goes Fraser. That beautifully dispatched. What football? nothing that Big Balm could do about cutting that one off. Perfectly positioned, and he's got it 30 metres out in front. Fraser heads towards goal, looking for his fourth, but the umpire moves off. And interesting to hear the comment of Kevin Neale at half time that he feels Fraser's a bit, he's a good competitor, but he's a bit short for full forward, Peter.
Well, there's no doubt that in the traditional sense he is, Ian, but when you have a look at the corresponding comments from Neil Balme about full forwards and the role that Neville Roberts plays, well, perhaps they see things differently. Off hands, Platten, the handball out, beautifully done. A chance for
Connelly.
Connelly it is. Wilson. And Philip Graham. Graham on the right boot, hooks it around, straight through the middle. His first goal. The Dogs now 18-11 to Norwood 5-2.
Very strong body work there by Wilbur Wilson. Whether he got into the back of that player pretty early, Connelly came across. Let's have a look at it as he... Oh no, he was just standing his ground. He did it well, used his body, enabled Philip Graham to hook it back, and that's straight through the middle. Another goal, it's his first. 18-11, plays 5-2, and Philip Graham averaging 13 disposals per game in 1984.
Well, I looked at Michael Ace a little while ago, and you almost get the impression that he's fed up with the attention he's getting, and, well, if he's out of the game, as I said before, Norwood have got problems. The Dogs go forward. Again, Graham goes in long. Oh, good mark again, Bruce Winter. He's taken some telling marks. Close to 300 games, and that was his seventh mark. Rowan Hellyer over to Danny Jenkins. No, he won't give it to Hine. Kelly lost front spot then. This man's very powerful. Brett Hannum, not the best handball I've seen. That put Jamie Thomas in trouble, but super stuff. Krieg got it over to Pryor. Pryor goes in long, but it's not accurate. Bruce Winter gets across, just saves the ball from the line. Kick away, not the best. It's going very close to the line. Thomas is over there, and the umpire will throw it in. Left half forward flank for the Bulldogs.
If you can forget for the moment that Bruce Winter's standing Wilbur Wilson, you'd think he's playing a fine game, and he is taking some good marks. But when you think of the damage Wilbur's done, that's got to go on the debit side as Beythien puts it out to Fraser again. And again, we see Bruce Winter come in and take a good mark. But I suppose with Wilbur Wilson, you can afford to go chase kicks and do all those things that you need to kick goals. But it's not easy for Bruce Winter. He doesn't know which player to grab as they come streaming down upon him through the half-back line, or his half-back line. Keith Thomas, caught on the left leg, puts it up to the half-forward line. That's an FAD against Platten. Not a lot going right for Norwood this afternoon. And it's David Payne to put them into attack. He gets a lead from Michael Annie, who's up at full forward at the moment. Big Jim comes to meet it, gets his hands on it. Rowe swings out the handball. It's back as far as McIntosh. He can't one grab it. Under pressure, gives away the handball. Jenkins in the pocket, hooks it back in towards full forward. Big leap there, back by Hannum. The ball goes out of play, or is it? Close to the line. Edwards and Jenkins, and the ball is out of play. Full forward left pocket.
119 plays 32. It's been a big performance from the Dogs. Certainly a worthy finalist if they keep this sort of football up. Menzel couldn't get through the pack. Great work, Platten. Fine handball. The Dogs run it out now through Krieg. Smothered by Thomas. Out comes Bubnver. A long way from centre half forward. Back it goes to Jamie Thomas. He'll use Philip Graham. Graham's got a space now if it sits for him. The lead is on now from Fraser. It won't get that far. Big Neil Hine intercepted quite well. Oh, that's a mistake. He gave it back to Philip Graham. He lines it up. 30 metres out. Two goals, Philip Graham. 19-11 plays 5-2. And they're casual, the Red Legs, and they're making mistakes.
Enormous pressure put on them in defence. But they're always someone running. Now, Hine got tackled, gave or tried to give away a handball. But look at the number of the Dogs player at the ball. All the time, there's 3-1. And swooping on every mistake that Norwood make and generally making them pay for it. Well, to the extent of 19 times they've paid for it. Well, they wouldn't say it's 19 errors by Norwood that caused all those goals. 19-11, plays 5-2, and we're into the 19th minute of the third quarter.
DeRouge against Hine. Hine got it down to Menzel, back to McIntosh. Swings out of trouble and gives it to Philip Gallagher. He kicks forward. He's going to find Greg Thomas with that kick. You'd expect that from Philip Gallagher. He's one of the best exponents of a kick, certainly in the last 10 years. Greg Thomas goes right in front of goal. A big leap there from Michael, and he couldn't take the mark. Tackles on. Payne in there as well. And umpire Rick Kinnear will bounce it. The breeze is going across the ground, as Robert and Keith said earlier. But if it's favouring an end, probably the Bulldogs. Beautifully down to Thomas. Thomas kicked it through, yes. A left foot goal from Thomas. Fine ruck work. The Redlegs have got six now. 6-2 to the Dogs, 19-11.
Yes, well, the legs have been in trouble everywhere, of course, and you've got to say that Keith Thomas is getting a few kicks himself, but unfortunately he's supposed to be standing Platten. He's only had nine, and Platten has had probably 19. So Keith Thomas, although that was a fine goal, once again on the debit side is the great game that's being played by John Platten, all over the ground. 19-11 to 6-2.
Back to the centre. Now the Dogs have already kicked four this quarter. It's been their worst quarter, in fact, statistically. Menzel back to McIntosh. He goes in long. Aces at centre-half forward. Got the punch away. Bung Ahern in there. Through comes Menzel, but it was Payne who snared the ball. See, the Norwood players are falling over a bit. Edwards comes out for the Dogs. Good Mark Connelly. Eyes on the ball. He should play it on. He has. Gee, they're confident. They're looking for Platten. Put one hand up, and he gets the free kick for a push right in the middle of the back. No doubt about Johnny Platten. There it is. Not a great deal of it, but it was technically there, I guess. Now, Johnny Platten will probably make the distance if his kicking so far this afternoon has been any indication. Kick number 20. Gives it plenty of air. That's five goals, Platten. We said it before. BOG means best on ground. 20 goals, 11 now, the Dogs, to 6-2, the Redlegs.
Well, Peter, what else can you say? Just running out of superlatives. The Dogs obviously hell-bent on getting that second posse or the double chance in the top three for the final five. And the way they're going about it, there's no question. Cowboy Neil must be terribly pleased with them. And bear in mind that he's a little bit thin in ruck, and as much that he's asking Beythien to do the work. And he's done particularly well today. DeRouge is helping him, but if he can get the likes of Cousin Moulds and this new player Joycey back in the side, gee, he's going to be laughing come final time.
McIntosh again. He's getting a few balls away from the centre, McIntosh, but they're not taking advantage of it. Scanlon fights hard, but gee, the Bulldog players around the ball. Too many of them. Here they go again. Bung Ahern kicked off the ground. Through goes Connolly. It sat for him beautifully. Platten's on the lead again. Not a good kick forward, though, but when it hits the ground, Platten's alive. He's got another free kick.
When it's your day, it's your day.
When you're hot, you're hot. Gee, Norsworthy's leading for him. Platten will use him. Norsworthy's got it now. Not far out, and I think he might have a pop shot. Well, I didn't have a close look at that decision, but Laurie Argent was very close to it. Norsworthy scored a goal with each of his last four kicks, so with that sort of conversion rate, one would back him in for this. He's kicked five. No, he didn't take the right goal post. He didn't have to. Now he's got six. 21-11 the Dogs, 6-2 Norwood.
I wasn't saying anything about the free kick. We're going to have another look at it, but it's just the fact that he gets the free kicks. Everything's going right for him at the moment. Now, you know...
Technically.
You know, yeah, technically perhaps, but on another day, Peter, he wouldn't have got it. He would have gone for holding the ball or something like that. But they're in front. They're playing the ball. He's playing a magnificent game. He deserves everything he gets. 21-11, 6-2.
Gee, they've kicked six goals this quarter now, so... they're starting to make a good one of it. Craig Bum through to McIntosh. Puts it out wide to Philip Gallagher. Finds that player. Boehm is right on him. Coming up to time on now. Gallagher will use Scanlon. Oh, he ducked the head. And paid for it. Boehm clears. Not very far. Gallagher's not running too quick today. Beautiful work, Edwards. Trevor Rowe kicks it to centre-half forward. Wilbur Wilson. Scanlon is still down, and he really did pay the penalty then for ducking the head. So there's 15 metres as well. Bruce Winter saying 20.
It's not often Bruce Winter says anything to the umpire, Peter.
No, he's probably a bit concerned about the last three free kicks around this spot. Gee, Scanlon is still down, and I guess that's a lesson. Oh, what a fine kick, Wilbur. Oh, it's hit the post. Well, I guess that sort of thing had to happen. 21-12, play 6-2.
Yes, a lot of concern with... Let's see how Scanlon got it. Now, he ducked the tackle, and I wouldn't be surprised if he got a knee there, Peter, as the player came through. I can't see how he hit it. Murray, can we play that again? Let's...
But you can imagine what Russell Ebert would have done, Ian. I'm not holding Russell Ebert up, but he would have stood high and held the ball high, probably, and missed all that.
Menzel. Jenkins. Andrew Jarvis. Beautiful tackle. Well done. Philip Graham bolts off. On the lead is Wilbur again. Oh, he's killing him. Out goes Bubnver. On the lead. Beautifully dispatched. Down he goes, close to 15 metres again. Frustration personified the Norwood defence. Kinnear goes back 15 metres, late on the scene. An attempted roundhouse right, very belated to try to spoil the ball. Justin Scanlon up on his feet, looking very groggy indeed. Gee, the legs can't take a trick. Bubnver at full forward at the moment, has booted one. That makes it two. Off they go again, 22-12. 6-2.
I tell you what, Ian, the way they're going, they could just about steal second spot off Glenel with their percentage this afternoon. Have a look at the way Bubnver leaps. Up he goes. It was a bit late, but full marks to Hellier for sort of putting in. I guess that we've seen too many occasions today where the red leg players are giving the impression that the endeavour's not there. There's Scanlon. Yeah, still a bit groggy.
Yes, Peter, a lesson not to duck the head, I suppose. And Jarvis, McIntosh, Menzel, sells the dummy well, drives long to the half-forward line, looking for Gallagher. Across comes Payne, almost Gallagher. Payne tries to get a handball out. Michael Aish can't get clear. The umpire said play on, but he's going to bounce it now. We're in the wrong stand when Michael Aish gets the ball. Everybody says it's holding the ball as soon as he picks it up.
Sometimes before he gets there.
That's right. Big leap to Rouge, but it went straight down there. Now to Thomas trying to get out with it. Menzel. Thrown away by Boehm. That is Boehm now. It must have been Thomas that threw it away. Centrals go forward. Philip Graham. He's got the pace to break clear. Out goes Fraser on the lead. One grab. Can't complete it. Platten again. Gets it out in front. Gets tripped. The umpire didn't see that one. Scanlon is coming off in defence. Andrew Jarvis gets it to Jenkins. Jenkins wobbles one to the half-forward line. Michael Aish almost. Craig Boehm, who appears to be playing centre half-forward. Down goes Jamie Thomas, and he's going to get free kick between wing and centre.
He got it for a trip. Michael Aish still out of the game. Cannot get into it. Trevor Rowe is right alongside of him. Jamie Thomas goes long to centre half-forward. Look at Bubnver on his own. You almost expect to see Bubnver at the Coliseum at Los Angeles. Tell you what, this man would go pretty well there too. Wilbur Wilson. Whew. How many marks has he taken? Eight, in fact. It's his 10th kick coming up. What a destroyer is Wilbur Wilson. He's kicked four goals. Kicked three in the second quarter in about 6 minutes. That was electrifying stuff. Of course, he's hit the post as well, and he's kicked a couple of points. Characteristic way he slides off to the left. That's his fifth goal. 23-12. The Dogs, Norwood, 6-2.
Well, what with Neil Balme and Ian Stasenowski and further afield there, reserves coach and Glenn Russell, what would they be thinking? They can't do much now, Peter. All they've got to do there is sit and cop it. Sweet. Fine lead on. I think it was meant actually for Fraser, and Wilbur nipped in and took a mark. Not the centers, a bit worried. Worried, doesn't matter who marks them or who kicks the goal, so long as they get them, and they've got 23.
Well, they've got eight this quarter. Here's the big Cowboy having a go at the Wrigleys. Tap away there from Mike Laney. Keith Thomas, handball, but to nobody. Brett Hannum. Vivian. He put it out to Fryer. Now, Fryer will go long. Norsworthy is going to be outnumbered. Lester Ross gave him a bit of a push, but not significant enough for the umpire to worry about it. Jarvis clears well. That's Dickinson. Should go long. He does. through to Platten. There he is again. He's everywhere, Platten. Over to Stephen Boehm. Boehm will find Bubnver in front again. Oh, he dropped the head. Gee. Only Beythien's allowed to drop the head and take marks. I've seen Bubnver do that before, and Kelly. Big punch away. Back to Vivian. They've got players everywhere. Oh, Krieg missed it with the hands. That's high. That's Adam's apple level, that one.
I'd have to agree with you, Peter. Swings it out. Andrew Jarvis. Now, where's he going to kick it? Balme on the lead. With him is Hannum. Balme out in front. Can't get it. Edwards can. Puts out a long hand ball. Connolly's going to have to work hard for this. Throws it away, but it was straight to David Payne. Payne goes in underground almost. It's not a good kick. And Ian Garouge gets down low and pulls in the mark. Just the check side of the centre line, who's on the lead. There'll be plenty. Don't worry about that. Out goes Wilbur now. He's going towards the half forward line. Mike Laney back in the fence. Siren sounds. The massacre continues. 23-12 Central, 6-2 Norwood.
Quarter time at the Elizabeth Oval, and Central Districts now have moved along to a 112 point advantage at three quarter time. Just recapping what we've seen so far this afternoon. At quarter time, it was 4 goals, 4 Centrals, 28 to Norwood, 1 straight goal, 6 points, a lead of 22. At half time, a mammoth second quarter by Centrals. They kicked 11-2 to move along to 15 goals, 6, 96 points to Norwood's 3 goals, 2, 20, a lead of 76 points. And now at three quarter time, with a third quarter of 8 goals, 6 by Centrals, they're now 23 goals, 12, 150 points to Norwood, 6 goals, 2 on 38, and a lead of 112 points. Well, we've already had a great weekend of stats. Of course, a million goals kicked yesterday to open round 14 of the SANFL. And we've already mentioned one stat today with Central Districts having their best quarter ever against Norwood, and a couple others they're heading towards. The highest winning scores against each other. Central's kicked 26 goals, 21 back in 1981. Well, they're almost on the way to breaking that stat. And the biggest winning margin against each other. Central's biggest winning margin prior to today was 102 points. And at the moment, as I said, they're leading by 112. And a couple of others they're heading for. Top goal kickers in Central's Norwood's matches. Greg Edwards got 8 at Elizabeth back in 1981. We've got Norsworthy, Platten and Wilson, Robert, who could be well on the way to breaking that record as well. So it's records all weekend.
It certainly has been. Some of the goal kicking's been superb this afternoon. Mark Norsworthy in particular has kicked very, very well for goal. He's got up into that forward line. He's showed a great deal of initiative. And it's good to see him striking a little bit of form. As you no doubt remember, a couple of years ago, Mark went across to Western Australia to play, and he didn't have a very successful time over there. And since he's come back to Central Districts, he hasn't been a regular member of the team on all occasions. But in the latter part of this season so far, he's been playing very, very well as second rover. Of course, John Platten obviously needs a little bit of assistance, and he takes a lot of the onus onto himself. And then, of course, it gives Mark Norsworthy a lot of opportunity, and he's taking advantage of that this afternoon.
We've just got the stats to hand so far, so we'll take a look at those now. Central Districts kicks 169 to Norwood 112. The marks are 59 to 46. Handballs 103 to 95. The frees have favoured Centrals at this stage, 25 to 21, but that's probably because their players have had the nose over the ball a lot more than Norwood. And the rucks out of centre, 14 to Centrals and 10 to Norwood. Well, Robert, when we came back from the halftime break, I got the impression that maybe Norwood were just going to get back in the game a little bit. They held Centrals in the early stage of that third quarter, but then, Centrals just went wild again.
They certainly did. Neil Balme tried to make a few changes to help the team. He put Craig Balme to full back. He shifted Jim Michael Annie into the ruck, and he put Lester Ross onto John Platten. Well, none of those had any real major effect on the Central District's onslaught. They've continued to play very well indeed. Admittedly, they did slow down a little bit in part of that quarter, but one would expect them to do that. But in the latter half of the quarter, we saw them once again playing some very smooth team play up into that forward line. And Norwood just can't seem to get any momentum whatsoever as far as their disposal is concerned, particularly with regard to the accuracy of it. On one occasion that quarter, Gary McIntosh had a ball in the centre of the ground, and he's usually a very good handballer, and he just knocked it out a little blindly. It came along the ground. Central Districts picked up the ball, went straight up into attack, and scored a goal. So there's just no way that Norwood are going to get anywhere unless they can lift their thinking and their whole attitude to the game, which is pretty difficult when you're 18 goals behind.
It's a shocking margin to have to come back from in the last quarter, isn't it?
And not too good.
When you look at football, you've got to have sort of key position players, and, well, all sides have had injuries, but Norwood haven't really got any key position players at the moment, have they?
They certainly haven't, and I don't know what Ian and Peter are seeing it like up there. They've broadcasted. What do you think about the go so far, every side of the one-horse race?
Well, as an exhibition, Robert, it's been superb, but as a contest, it was ruined perhaps as early as halfway through that second quarter, as we called it. Incidentally, bad news for the leg supporters. Tom Moorhurst is in hospital with concussion, and he'll possibly spend the night there. Well, that's bad news when he took that heavy knock. I think it was in the first quarter. Hasn't helped the scene, but, Peter, it looked like the legs were never going to win it after the first quarter.
No, actually, you and I had a bit of a chat even during the first quarter in, and we both thought they were gone. Poor old Neil Balme, having a talk to Michael Ace just before the break. I don't know what he was saying, but Michael Ace obviously frustrated. Nevertheless, the red legs go in. Payne gave it to Gallagher. On the lead is Hine. Oh, he dropped it, but he's got paid. Well, I tell you what, it wasn't a mark. There's no way known that was a mark, but he paid a couple earlier. He paid one to Wilbur Wilson. There it is. But that's control. My name's not what it is. But perhaps
what,
it was,
what is it again?
Lou Richards, I think. Perhaps it was there was some sympathy in that, or he blew the whistle too early. Nevertheless, it's a goal. Two goals, Neil Hine. Everyone's booing. His second kick, too. 7-2 Norwood. The Dogs 23-12.
Well, I suppose if you can say what can Norwood do, they obviously can't win the game, but they've got to come out of it with more credit, because if they, you know, the Trubs got tradition, they've got to keep their heads high and just got to work hard and try to improve their score. And I suppose the main thing now, we've got to ask ourselves, can Norwood get into double figures and kick 10 goals?
Well, they should. Beythien. Michael Aney got it down. Well done to Thomas. Super quick handball, McIntosh. He busts the pack. Puts it out very wide. Andrew Jarvis. He's playing up forward, or possibly centre wing now. That's Greg Thomas and Albie Menzel. We'll have to go back, Menzel. Neil Hines running around up there for him. Menzel will probably put it out in front of goal. Yes, he does. Neil Hine. He's in there. Two grabs. No, couldn't mark the ball. Michael Aish. That's a fine handball, Aish. Payne missed it, though. The tackle was applied by Platten, but umpire Kinnear will bounce it. Well, Bunga Hearn there is limping. He's got an ankle problem. Down it comes. Jamie Thomas wobbles one away. That will run out. The umpire will throw it in.
Stephen Trigg coming back next week, according to Cowboy Neil. And I would think that it would need someone to be injured for him to get back in the side. And I would think Bunga Hearn would be trying to keep that ankle injury all to himself. Well, the handball from Boehm then went straight to Michael Aish. Thomas back to Aish in the 1-2. But his kick is not very well directed. Jamie Thomas takes off. Puts it out in front of Hannum. Coming across is big Jim Michael Aney. He'll need help. Oh, Jim did that well. No pressure put on him at all. Kicks in long. Hine and Wright. Hine in front. 1-2 grabs. The umpire didn't play that one. As Central Spirit yet again. Edwards gets it over to Wright. And he's got time to bounce it out of defence. Casually goes along, gives it now to Platten, and the flea goes off. Played like a flea in a bottle. Kick number 22 up towards Fraser. One grab, can't complete it. Connelly in there to help him, but Fraser doesn't need him. Oh, yes, he does now as he kicks a small little one into the corner. Ross getting back, having disposed of Norsworthy. He comes across field and gives Winter a chance. Now, gee, he's going to have to go. Coming down upon him quickly was Bubnver. Showed a lot of pace to get across there. Bubner's leg, got to get a free kick, and he's got it full forward left pocket. Bubner's only got it about 35 metres out, the angle about 45 degrees. Crowd 6,066, and would have many more at home. Hope you're enjoying the exhibition that the Dogs are putting on for you. Platt, Kelly, stack up of players and a bounce.
Well, Platten, he's in everything. There he is. It's not only his football ability that gets your attention, it's those locks of hair. Up goes Bubnver. Oh, the whistle's gone. Someone was being held onto it. It was Ross. He got it out. Jarvis. Long kick. Danny Jenkins is outnumbered. But he's a fighter, Danny Jenkins. Edwards got it over to Krieg. Krieg has made a couple of mistakes with the hands of late. Norsworthy. Oh, he trapped that ball very well. Beythien. Well done, Beythien. A bit of finesse. Silva. Cannot keep him down. He's found somebody. You can bet on that. No doubt about it. Connelly. What a wonderful footballer Wilbur is. Gee. 5 goals. Given away plenty. Add to that, he's very colourful and the crowd love him. 8 kick. Connolly. No, they won't kick a goal with it. Just offline, a point. 23-13 to 7-2.
Norwood have made plenty of moves during the afternoon, but few have been successful. Some being forced upon them, of course, with the loss of Tom Warhurst. Kelly at full back at the moment. He puts it out to Jim Michelani, who's having a run in ruck. He went to full forward at one stage. At the moment, Neil Hine is there. Obviously, Neil Balme is changing his ruckman there. Thomas started as a rover, still roving, looking for Dickinson. That's a good mark. Dickinson elects to play off court on the left leg, puts in a long one. Right at the back is Hine. The big fellow did it well. Gives a chance now. Payne puts out a long one. Albie Menzel should be a walking goal. Bolts his first. And Norwood are getting closer to that double figure. 8-2, plays 23 goals, 13.
Well, the big chap Neil Hine did some good work then, because for a moment there, Wright appeared to have the run of the ball just there. But Hine telescoped the hand, brought it back, gave Payne the chance, and the little chap put it through. Yes, Michael Wright's coming off. He's had trouble with that ankle all year, to be replaced by DeRouge. He's going straight down into the change rooms, no doubt. But that ankle was causing him trouble. You can tell, Ian, I think the way he runs, he hasn't got much freedom with his run, has he?
I have to agree with you, Peter. It's a very measured run. Norsworthy. Hannum backing up superbly. The kick is not that good. Wilbur's got a wait for it. What's he going to do with it? Philip Graham beats one, can't beat the second. Good tackle. Jarvis, likewise a good tackle put on him. Boehm jams it onto his boot quickly and has kicked it into touch. Well, it's still in play. But Lester Ross put paid to that and conceded a point.
Well, Stephen Boehm's not really a goal kicker. He's wobbled a couple in that general direction this afternoon, but they haven't done the right thing for him. Difference is 102 points. Rowan Hellyer. That's not a good kick. Big Craig Bum. Can't punch it away. Greg Thomas. Balm. He just ran into Craig Balm, which is not the most delightful thing to do on a Sunday afternoon. That was a bit high. Laurie Argent saw it. Wayne Pryor, he plays cricket. Pryor takes off. Kicks it to centre-half forward. The big leap there. A good leap by Rowan Hellyer. Keem provides the run. Of course, the Pryors are related. Mark Pryor and Wayne Pryor, they're brothers, I think. Wayne Pryor did a stint with World Series cricket a while back. Payne takes a mark on the outer side of the ground.
Payne has been useful, but his chances have been limited. Keem puts it in long. The back of the pack, Michael Ace can't get the sit. Menzel can. Goal number two, puts it up high. Hasn't made the distance. Going towards the line. Menzel again. Wanting it is Thomas. Sills one pack. Puck has another go. And two shots for goal. Have produced exactly now. That one's out of bounds on the foot.
Gee, deserves a third after that.
Gee, Peter, how'd you like that hat?
Well, they've got cowboys all over the place here, or is that an Indian?
Bill Guy.
Nosworthy. Kicks it out long. Big Jim from behind. DeRouge in front. Here's a chance. Greg Thomas. I think he'd be the quickest Norwood player. Into the square. Neil Hine comes over the top. I don't think he got near it then. Bunga Hearn takes it across the line. The umpire to throw it in. Gee, they love the hats out here. Yes, yes. More.
Good
seven,
boy.
That's right.
Good boy.
He knew all about it.
Beythien. He remembered us.
Beythien in front. Hine got the tap over. Aish. Keith Thomas. Here's a chance. Craig Balme. He kicked it straight through the middle. And Neil would have been delighted with that one. First goal to Craig Balme. They got now 9-2. They're getting close to that 10.
He lost his footy as well. I mean, his foot all came back. Michael Aish gave a chance there to Thomas. Back to Balme, and he certainly didn't pull the kick so much so that his boot went halfway as far as the ball. But Norwood haven't had a big day at all. It's an understatement of the year. He's averaging 17 hit-outs per game, but I don't think he would have done that today.
See, there's another one. That's got a sheriff's badge on it. No doubt about the influence of the Cowboy out here. They love him, so they should. That was a bit high for Albie. In the centre of the ground. I think Johnny Platten slowed down a bit. He might even come off for a rest. The kick is to centre half forward. Oh, big leap there and a good mark taken by Jamie Thomas. He's limping. Triggy's looking pretty good for next week. There's a few lads with injuries out there. He floats one long. Keem, Philip Graham as well. Close to the line. It's out now. The umpire will throw it in.
Played 10 minutes of the final quarter. And what a ball over. Looking forward to the big clash between third and what sixth it is. And Norwood a chance of getting into the five had they had a big win today. But the Dogs have certainly put paid to that. Well, for a man who's got a bung ankle, he made some pace there, but that's about all he can do. Maybe he's looking at Stephen Trigg, looking over his shoulder. Platten up, Dickinson there. Going through, Vivian hasn't got the football. Taruja is short, but he's going into Conlon. One-handed, Beaton's after it. Back to DeRouge. The big fellow's got it. Gets shepherded and goes out for the short pass. Platten, one-handed. Well, he can walk on water this afternoon. He's had a brilliant day. Gee, there's plenty of leads there. This one's going to Norsworthy. Not one of his better passes. He had to stand the ground as the thundering herd came down on him. Through goes Vivian again. Another free kick. And who's he going to pass to in the pocket? I can't see past the post. And it is Fraser on the lead. And he's got it in the full forward left pocket. Just to fill you in, viewers at home, we sit at the back of the stand and there's one great big post that's holding up the complete roof that cuts off that forward left pocket. So there it is there. We refer to the monitor, which has got a far better picture for you. And it's right through the middle. First Wright Fraser kicks his fourth goal.
Well, they've plugged away and obviously a lot of the intensity's gone out of the game for the Bulldogs. They know they've won it. But this is the lead-up. Vivian got his second free kick. And he passed it off to Fraser on a lead. There's no doubt about the Bulldogs. They've done it well, and they want that second spot. They want top spot, in fact. And they're going to be a worthy finalist, along with the Magpies, the Tigers, and the Panthers. But the big mystery is, who's going to get that fifth spot? And whoever does get it, are they going to be any good with it?
DeRouge, McIntosh with strength. But the umpire intervenes, and McIntosh just a little disappointed. Norwood one goal to get their double figures. They got 20 minutes to do it, so every chance indeed. Hellier hasn't played a bad game. He's certainly worked hard. Dickinson at centre wing. Who's giving a lead? Or smothered off the boot. Big Balme's going to need help. Gets out the handball back to Dickinson. Greg Thomas hooks the ball in hope more than anything. Out comes Hine, thumps it clear, Boehm in defence. Thomas, Platten, almost teasing the defence. Graham for Thomas, oh, out went Thomas. Oh, that was a very high hit against Boehm. The Dog players want to go on with it. In they come, Norsworthy, doesn't he love a scrap? He's in there as well. Craig Boehm trying to shrug off six or seven very angry players. Umpire Laurie Argent having a word to say to Craig Boehm. Jamie Thomas has got problems of his own. Peter Marker.
Well, if Laurie Argent was going to have a word to Craig Boehm, why didn't he do it much earlier? Okay, Thomas went down. Whether it was illegal or not, I can't say. I wasn't watching it, but Laurie Argent was a little bit late with his warning. In front was Michael Aney. A good mark. If there are any fights out there, perhaps Norwood can win those, but certainly the game is over as a contest. Young Ross was off. Out it goes to Winter. Been a good player, Winter, notwithstanding the dominance from time to time of Wilbur Wilson. Thomas off, Van Dommel back on. Bunger Hearn didn't take the mark, but he controlled the ball back to Hannum. Hannum in turn to Hearn. Hearn's certainly nursing an ankle injury. So is Thomas.
And Van Dommel has gone back on the ground, Peter.
Yes, they've got a few ankle injuries. Hopefully, Jamie Thomas will be okay. Van Dommel certainly loosened up a bit. He's had plenty of time to give attention to it. Keane puts Norwood back in. Oh, dear idea, Ian. It's, do you get the impression that some of the Norwood players are not interested? I know that's pretty harsh criticism.
Well, Peter, their forward line's so confused, it looks like a Chinese fire practice, I reckon. You know, there's just nothing there at all. And they just, they've got, well, I think you're probably right. Not much going for them today. Kine, basic mistakes. Edwards and Dommele. Wilbur Wilson heads towards goal, on its way, and the umpire said he's missed. And gee, there's disappointment in this stand. 24-15 to 9-2. One thing that Norwood has done well is kick for goal.
Yes, they've been accurate. Gee, Wilbur was just put off balance with the kick. No doubt he would have kicked it if the pressure hadn't been there. Bubnver. Oh, he thought about it. He's off.
He was off.
I reckon that's the one thing that the umpires can't, or one of the things they just can't read is when a player's off. It's his 11th kick. Have a look at Platten. He won't get a jump at that. Too late on the scene. Winter got the kick away. Edwards and Bubnver. Well, Bubnver thought about it again. What a great athlete he is. He's played a fine game too at centre-half forward. Wilbur's on his own, but Bubnver will go for goal. Not a good kick. It's a floater. In front, Craig Kelly. Good mark. I think he might swing to grandstand side. Craig Kelly, yes.
Playing in defence, Peter, he started his career with Norwood in defence at centre-half back, didn't he? As only in recent times they've tried him at centre-half forward.
You did right, Ian, yes. He came from Prince Alfred College and he wasn't centre-half back. Craig Balme gets a boo, which is to be expected, I guess, when you consider what the crowd thought he did before. Over it went to Thomas. That was Greg Thomas. Payne's got it now. Gee, Norwood have got a chance. No, the pressure was applied again. That went through Beythien. In comes Big Jim. Menzel also. Graham. Gallagher. Menzel again. Gee, could we get 10 goals? Greg Thomas onto the right boot. No, it's a boomerang ball, but not far enough. It hit the point post.
And do you think Jim Michelani's very rotten, Peter? You can just see him go to the left out of your screen there. Big Jim wanted a handball or a small kick in the right forward pocket. He was 10 metres out on his own, and I think possibly when you get under pressure, Peter, like this, the team ship goes out, or the teamsman ship goes out of the side completely. You just lose confidence in your fellow players, and all you're intending is on is getting the kick away. 11 kicks coming up. Mark Norsworthy. Gee, you should have seen him run 50 metres to get into the action when Craig Balme got caught in that sandwich with all those central players. Guess who's got the football as he kicks it right in up towards full forward. Getting back is Bungahern, and the ball goes through for the minor score. 9-3 Norwood, 24-15. Big Jim, like most of his mates, hasn't had a big day, but he's been gnawed to the core for a long time.
Well, I'll tell you what, the Bulldogs are not finishing this game off. Dickinson, good tackle, and now, who's that going to go in favour of? Norsworthy. Well, Keith Thomas threw it back and made sure it landed right where Keith Thomas wanted it to. It's one thing about playing out here, it's always a bit of fun. In comes McIntosh. Whoa, excuse me. I'm glad he missed. Vivian would have landed in the grandstand. Was that in the back or wasn't it? Yes, I think even Wilbur concedes that. Chris Winter. He has played well, Bruce. To centre-half forward, Big Jim got under the ball too far. Through goes Albie Menzel. He can get kicks. He's got a big heart too, Albie. That's a push in the back. Gee, I don't mind giving free kicks away.
Beythien lumbers out through centre-half back, puts it out wide. Michael Ace into the action. And he's got one of his few kicks. Number 8 coming up, and for Michael Ace, that's a drought, I can tell you. Albie Menzel. He's 45 metres out. Payne gives a lead, but he's also going back into Danny Jenkins, right in the left forward pocket. And here's a chance to kick 10 goals. Can they do it? That is the question. It's only 20 metres out. An erstwhile half-back flanker, centre wingman, playing in the forward pocket today in place of Neville Roberts. Kick number 13 coming up. Coming back after an injury. His condition to be a little suspect. He loves the game of footy. Danny Jenkins guides it through. I think he's got a point. Oh, goal, is it? Oh, 1 point. No, 1 point. 9-5 Norwood, 24-15 Centrals.
Peter Beythien will kick it out for the Dogs. There's still plenty of movement on. Trevor Rowe goes for the lead, and then now Michael Ace is following him. It's a turnabout. Edwards. He's played a fine game, Edwards. Kicks it out to his position, centre wing. That was his 12th kick. Keem in hot pursuit is Connelly. Keem gave it over to the big man, Neil Hine. Philip Gallagher. Gallagher will go long and high to centre half forward. Up goes Thomas. Gee, that was a fine mark for little man. Big Jim was behind him. Now there's no one home at the moment. No one in the square at all. 13 kicks. Greg Thomas. It's a little chip. Now he wanted Albie Menzel. Over the top, Dickinson. Free kick will go to Menzel though. We'll push in the back. Dickinson probably would have kicked the goal in any event. Menzel has one. He's a little phantom in the forward line, Menzel. This is his 8th kick this quarter. He's certainly shown the way to some of his colleagues. 2 goals, Menzel. There it is. 10 goals to the legs. 10-4, trailing the Bulldogs. 24-15.
No questioning of Albie Menzel's heart, his spirit, his courage. And he's prepared to get in and get the ball out. But unfortunately, Albie, since he busted that leg, must have lost half a metre in pace. But he puts himself in position to get the ball. And on that occasion, he won the free, got his 2nd goal. And I agree that he's certainly shown his teammates and something about getting the ball this afternoon.
Hine, Aish. Aish fell over. Now Menzel again. He's still got the kick away. We heard the usual yell, holding the ball. Edwards. Oh, dummy beautifully. Gee, he's an improver. An improved player. Wilbur Wilson. Couldn't take the mark. Follows it up well, though. That's a throw. Don't forget to join us at 5 o'clock for 1 hour of the highlights from the SCG clash. The Swans and Collingwood. But there's still plenty of action left in this game. The Redlegs improving and the Bulldogs dropping away a bit in.
Stephen Keem, yes, for sure. They've got it passed up, though, Peter. Michael Annie over the top, and he's got one at last. Here's a chance for number 10. Oh, they've already got number 10. Big Jim has taken 6 marks and a chance to kick his first goal from his 9th kick. Only about 35 metres out. He used to be a specialist full forward. Let's see what he could do. Yes, he's nudged that one through. Norwood 11-4, Central Districts 24-15.
Big Jim's having a clap. Not many claps out here for the Norwood players. Keem went in long. That was a good mark. Watch the injury to Pry there. That's how they happen. Right in the meaty part, just above the base of the spine, and they do hurt a bit. 24-15 the Dogs, Norwood 11-4.
At the centre bounce. 22 minutes gone. Hine gets the tap away. Dumped clear, however, by Krieg to the half forward line. Connolly on the lead goes Van Dommel. Slips it back to Connolly in the 1-2. Caught him on the wrong foot. Made it hard for Fraser. Kelly came over the top and absolutely destroyed him. Connolly buttering up again, but Jarvis sees the ball off him. Keem's got to go hard. With him there is Rob Fraser. Put the ball out of play in the full forward right pocket. Central's in this quarter, just to bear up Peter Marker's thoughts about stopping a little bit. Only kicked 1-2, whereas Nord have added 5 too easily their best quarter. But we saw that with Woodville's yesterday against South when they kicked 11-4 in the last quarter. Maybe no matter what you do, it's hard to keep your concentration when the game is well in your keeping. Wilbur Wilson. Getting underneath the ball was Jarvis. A chance now for Vivian if he can find it, but Dickinson can't either. He's having trouble. Still searching for it. Edwards did that well. Got back on top of the ball. And he gets a round of applause for keeping the ball within touch in the forward line. A bounce down inside his half forward line. About 45 metres out. Bubnver jams it onto his boot, smothered. Dickinson in defence has worked hard. Hooks it around the corner to Thomas. Pryor there with him, going through Edwards, but left the footy behind. Ross, still grovelling for the ball, can't get it out. McIntosh comes into lens support, but another bounce down on the left half forward flank of the Dogs.
We're approaching 25 minutes. Umpire Kinnear. Crowd silent, of course. The game all over is a contest, probably as early as the first quarter. Bubnver showing tremendous pace. Back to centre half forward, Van Dommel. Beautiful disposal. Van Dommel's nursing that left ankle. But he had the pace to get around for that super kick in from Bubnver. Rene Van Dommel. Nice Dutch name for you. Took plenty of time over it. Put it through. Fine goal. His first. 25-15 the Dogs. 11-4 the Redlegs.
Dickinson, when he went to get that ball off Bubnver in the forward pocket, the boy's so tight he couldn't even call after him. And Bubnver showed extraordinary speed. Look at Dickinson now trying to get the ball. He can't pick it up. He's just dog tight. He still goes after it. Exhausted, and Bubnver just took off. And what a fine dispatch of the ball to the lead there of Van Dommel. And despite the injured angle, he popped on his first. 25-15 to 11-4. Always a big disposal boy for Central's. 22 average this season.
Therouge for the dog. Gets the big punch forward. Winter in front. Michael Ace fighting for it. Another bounce. Bulldogs are two goals off their record high score, and we see Platten coming off for the Dogs. He'll get a big cheer. Jamie Thomas coming back on. That's the best man on the ground, John Platten. I tell you what, his heart is just about as big as his body. 24 kicks, 9 handballs, 5 marks, and he's kicked 5 goals. You can't do much better than that. As Trevor Rowe wobbles one forward. Stephen Keem showing plenty of pace. Pirouette's out of trouble very well. Kelly caught, threw it away. Fraser dived for the ball and got a high one. His free kick. Fraser's kicked 4. He's done it quietly. He's had some good friends up there, though. Wilbur's got 5. Norsworthy 6. Platten 5. So they've had some fine goal kickers. This may just be beyond Robert Fraser's distance. Yes, legs a bit tired. Rowe in front, couldn't take the mark. Off hands, McIntosh. He clears out with a long kick. Philip Graham behind. 2 grabs, good mark.
He's played well, Peter.
Yes, he has, Ian. Oh, look at that. Wilbur Wilson's got 20 yards space. Nonchalant handball. Boehm will give it back to Wilbur. He's in trouble now. In big trouble.
Appearance here by Thomas. Gets the ball to McIntosh. McIntosh. Wilbur's going to try to run him down, but Gallagher's in support of that player. Gives it to Greg Thomas on the half forward line. He's got no one to kick to. No one at all. There's no one home. Big Neil Hines going to have to run back. Payne's flying with Beythien. Took it like a rugby full back and puts it out wide to DeRouge. Norsworthy's getting out to help that player, and DeRouge will give him the handball as it goes over the top of Keem. Back to DeRouge in the double play. He strides across the centre line, kicks long to the half forward. Coming in is Lester Ross, got a shocking bounce. Michael Ace didn't though. He'll put it out to Gallagher. Too far for that player, and found Vivian. Norsworthy, so easy the Dogs, puts it out wide corner. DeRouge, I don't think he really wanted that.
It's a bit tight, I think.
Puts it up high. Fraser. Kelly. Leaved off him there by Jamie Thomas, I think it was, is it? Or was it Tom? It was Robert Fraser. Sorry, Robert Fraser kicked 5. 26-15 to 11-4.
Well, as I mentioned before, he's unobtrusive about his work, and okay, he might not have the height for the traditional full forward, but with 5 goals, that's pretty handy, and he does some good work around that forward area as well. So good performance. 26-15 the Dogs. Order 11-4. We're well into time on. Not much time left.
1 goal, and the Dogs have equaled their record score that Rick told you about. That's out at Elizabeth. 26-15. They've kicked. Bubnver is going to give them a chance to do it. A long kick in towards the half forward line. Winner coming to meet it. Should take it easy. Thought about running through Connelly.
He's taken a few marks here.
Yes, he's played well, Peter. He's taken 9 marks, and he's had a lot of hard work to do. 14th kick coming up. He didn't get a kick in actual fact. He handballed for the 11th time as Andrew Jarvis goes to the outer side. Philip Graham takes the mark, and he's got it on the half back line. Elects to play on, casually on the left foot, puts it up to the half forward line, and Bubnver can't take that one. Rowan Hellyer, Menzel, Thomas. Over the half forward line with a high kick. Hine, Beythien, Hine in front at the back row. Got a bad one. Michael Aish taps it back. Here's a chance now for Thomas if he can pick it up. Payne wants it in the pocket. Michael Aish is there as well. Gives it back. Thomas jams it onto his boot quickly and pops it through the goal. That's Thomas's second, and Norwood have got number 12 on the ball.
Well, that's their sixth goal for the quarter. In fact, they were 6-2 at three-quarter time, so they've doubled their score. The Cowboy droops the head. I don't think he's too rapt about what's going on in this last quarter. He would have liked the game to finish three-quarter time. But Michael Aish was involved in this exchange, and whilst the sting has gone out of the game, it's not over till the final bell. Keith Thomas brought up his second goal. 12-4 plays 26-15.
At the bounce, DeRouge over Michael Annie. Vivian got it forward. Wilbur Wilson, a chance. Krieg, bad bounce, has to go back and get it. Ross gives it to Winter. A fine handball out wide, which will give the run to Danny Jenkins. There's the siren to end the game. A big win here out at Central Districts. 26-15, 171 is defeated Norwood, 12-4-76. A fine performance by Central Districts. They led 4-4 to a goal at quarter time, 15-6 to 3-2. A magnificent second quarter, kicking 11 goals, 15-6 to 3-2 at half time, 23-12 to 6-2 at three quarter time, and ran out winners 26-15 to 12-4. And Peter, that is definitely a top three performance.
Yes, it is, Ian. I'd have to agree with that. And I guess that it's important that the sides that we have in the top three or top four are good. They're all good. Port, Glenelg, the Dogs and the Panthers are very good sides. They're all worthy finalists. But having a look at Norwood, I think the thing that happened is what we all feared. Robert's not playing. They haven't got enough forwards to kick enough goals. And on a big oval like this, they just haven't got the pace. It's not just run. I think that genuinely some of their players lack pace against some of these Dog players.
Well, Peter, I think the proof is in the eating of the pudding there, in as much that they're running players. I'm talking Norsworthy, 6 goals. John Platten, 5 goals. Wilbur Wilson, 5 goals. Some of their running players have absolutely massacred Norwood. Keith Thomas battled hard. Albie Menzel in the last quarter did some useful work, but really their run-on players just didn't provide them with enough drive at all.
Yes, you're right, Ian. And I really can't find a good player on the Norwood side. Tom Warhurst went off early, and of course he's their top defender. He's one of the best defenders in the state. He went off. Bruce Winter fought hard, but of course Wilbur Wilson got 5 on him. But all in all, Norwood not nearly good enough, and we'll now join Rick Keegan down in the Central District rooms.
Thank you, Peter. Well, certainly a great win by Central Districts this afternoon. I'm sure all the crowd down here and the players are most happy at the moment. Kevin Neale congratulating his players on a job well done, a 95-point victory over Norwood. So we've still got a great situation at the moment for that place in the final five, with Sturt still hanging in there, even though they're in something of a slump at the moment. But with West and now Norwood losing today, Sturt just still holding on. We should see some great games in the coming weeks to decide who will be in that fifth place, and it looks like Central's may even be on the way to a double chance in 1984. Do hope that you have enjoyed our coverage this afternoon from Elizabeth. We've certainly enjoyed bringing it to you, and of course we've got many more coming your way. And in fact, Kevin Neale may be just on the way with us now, so we'll be able to have a quick word to him. I'm sure he's going to be absolutely rapt. You can do no more than win by 95 points, and of course, even though he went in with a few ruck problems, they've certainly done extremely well indeed. And Kevin's just on his way now, got a smile on his face, which is great to see. Kevin, congratulations. You can do no more than win by 95 points. A great victory.
Yeah, we're under a bit of pressure, Rick, and you know, they had a bit of a challenge to react to, and they did it very well. I'm very pleased with them.
You went in with a few ruck problems. I thought Beythien and Drews did a great job all day.
Oh yes, you know, they're probably not, or haven't been recognised ruckman. Beythien is. I still believe he's as good as we've got here. He's a little short in height, but DeRoods did a top job. Every time we've had him up in the seniors this year, he's really given his best, and I thought we covered that fairly well today.
What about that second quarter? Just hard to believe, wasn't it?
Yes, it's, you know, when you sit up there when things aren't going right, the bounce of the ball seems to go over your head and go between your feet, and everything doesn't work. But we were sitting up there and just everything fell into place. It didn't matter where they ran the ball, landed in their arms, and, you know, they Well, they played as a team, and I think they ran and used their voices a bit better today and backed up well. And, you know, when they got into trouble, there was always one or two there to help them, which, you know, was good.
You had very good use of the centre square, and I thought your rebound from half back was there as well. What about your smaller players, Platten and Norsworthy? Great effort again.
Yes, they played really well. You know, Platts, of course, is, you know, everyone knows, a great champion. Norser, his last five or six games have been excellent, really, especially, you know, he started to really pick his game up when Platts assumed the first Rover's position, and he's really done well. But you know, there's some top efforts today. Young kid on the wing, Edwards, I thought had a super game.
Thanks, Kevin. Wish you luck the remainder of 1984.
Thank you.
Well, do hope you've enjoyed our coverage this afternoon, and we'll catch up with you next week.
This has been another Seven Sport presentation, brought to you by your Mitsubishi Motors dealer, NEC, and Hallett Brick.